Good morning, everybody. Can you hear me?
Yes, Judge. Good morning.
Good morning, Judge. Good
morning. All right. Thank you, Ron, for organizing everything so efficiently. Mr. Gaffney, good morning. Mr. Griffin, good morning. Mr. Dickey, good morning. I hear a dog there, too. Whose dog is that? All right. Well, good morning. This is a drug court session, and I've been provided with information from each of our senior probation officers regarding the status of our participants. Of course, as you all know, the court has not had an opportunity to have in-person or video communications with the participants, which is something that best practices suggests be done. And I appreciate the efforts. Before I talk to anybody, I want to say I appreciate the Herculean efforts by all of the probation officers for gathering the relevant information from the participants, working with the participants, assisting them in downloading any required software. Some of our participants are more technologically savvy than others. And so I just want to, before we even begin, sincerely thank all of the officers and all of the participants who are on board and who have made great efforts to be with us this morning. I do know before I start any conversations, I know that we have Mr. Griffin, our senior probation officer, with our first slot of individuals this morning. And I also recognize that we have some pre-programmed people that we can discuss. And so I'm trying to see who we have up on the screen for you, Mr. Griffin, but I have received your updates. And so who am I seeing up in the corner? It's Mr. Frias, correct, Mr. Frias?
Yes, how you doing, Judge?
Mr. Frias, I'm doing well. How are you doing today?
Oh, man, we're pulling through with this pandemic. Okay. We're getting by. Yeah.
Tell me what's going on with you, with your family. What's your situation like, Mr. Frias? You've been doing well with us, and I'm happy, and I'm really happy to see you, okay? So tell me what's going on.
Likewise. So, like I told Mr. Griffin, in some sort of way or another, we've all been affected. So my job has closed down. Burlington Coat Factory has closed down temporarily. So I'm seeking unemployment. I'm on top of my daughter. She's doing homeschooling.
Okay.
Right. Yeah. So
Is she on break from school now, or is she in school this week?
No, she's on break. And it's unfortunate, too, because her principal was diagnosed with COVID. Yeah, it's really, they sent us an email. It's been really, you know, it's been a real shot in the dark with, you know, going outside. The only place I try to go to is to the grocery store. I have my mother here living with me, and she's elder, so she would be at risk.
Of course.
You know?
Of course. Yeah. No, I think that's immensely wise of you, Mr. Frias, to limit. I've done the same thing, and I've only been out of my house three times, and those were only to go to the grocery store. So that's absolutely right. We have to maintain that. How's your mom doing right now? Is she okay?
Doing well. She's doing well. I just got an Xfinity put in the house. So first we were just doing the apps like Hulu and what have you. Right. But since we've been spending more time in the house, we've had to put some cable in here. So okay. she's all good. She's been resting even more. Watching the Spanish channel, Univision.
Good. And all. That's fantastic. There are probably what on Xfinity, just the regular basic, I think in the 700s, there's like 55 Spanish speaking channels in a
right.
row.
Yeah,
I cruise through them every once in a while myself, you know?
Right. So grace of God, good. We're comfortable. Thank God, man.
Yeah, no, and again, you know, I know that you're the first person I'm talking to, Mr. Frias, today, and I'm going to have probably a pretty long day, but that's okay with me. This is what I want to do, and this is what I'm lucky enough to be asked to do by my supervisor. So, what's going on with? I expect that I'm going to hear from a lot of people the same thing I heard from you about your employment situation. What's been your experience with treatment? You've been still attending Legacy?
Well, yeah, I just did one on the, because I'm once a month now, so I did one on the 4th.
Okay.
With Victoria Heifetz on the 4th, and I'm scheduled for the 30th again. So.
Okay, and that was via telephone? Was that?
It was right here on Zoom.
Right here on Zoom, okay. Because we've got different platforms that different treatment providers are using, but you're doing okay, Mr. Frias, and your family's
yes,
doing okay.
Yes, I am.
Definitely. All right, good. Well, I got to tell you this: you're looking well. You know, I still have my robe on and my tie, if you can see here, because of course these are court matters.
Right.
So, but I really appreciate your time, your efforts. You're doing well, Mr. Frias, and you know, I'm really happy to hear that you and your family are safe. Okay,
I appreciate that, man. I'm glad to touch base with you guys too, man.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, this is you know, sometimes I have difficulty pulling information out of people, and I'm sure I will today. But you've always been a very interactive, very intelligent, pleasant person, and so I appreciate that, Mr. Frias. I commend you. Please keep up the good work. Stay in touch with Mr. Griffin. If you're encountering any issues, problems, you let us know, okay?
I sure will.
All right. Well, my best to your family, my best to you, and I look forward to talking to you again soon, okay?
All right. Till next time. You guys have a blessed one.
All right. You as well.
Take care.
Mr. Gaffney, did you have something you wanted to say?
I did not, Your Honor.
Okay, I thought you were like waving in the back.
Oh no.
All right.
I said goodbye to Mr. Frias.
Excellent. Thank you. And all right. So and good morning, Miss Maureen. I do see you as well. How are you today?
I'm doing something. Daddy's doing something. Hold on.
Judge?
Yes, sir.
I believe we have another participant in. He's under James iPhone guest, but I don't know which one it is.
Would it be Mr. Gatson?
Yes.
Mr. Gatson, good morning.
Good morning, Garrenger.
How are you today?
Fine, yourself?
I'm doing well, Mr. Gatson. And again, I'm going to go through and have a brief conversation with all the participants like I try to do when we meet personally in court, okay? And so I'm just going to ask you broadly, how are you doing? What's going on with you and your family? Are you all okay?
Yeah, everybody's okay. Everything going well. Just try to stay clean. Try to stay clean. Everything like that.
All right. And are you also attending treatment sessions at Legacy?
Yes, I just did one yesterday with Marion.
Okay, and I was just talking to Mr. Frias, who's a Phase 2 gentleman, and he was saying that Legacy, they've been able to do it via Zoom. Have you been able to do that?
Or yeah, I do doing Zoom.
Okay, and that's working out for you?
Yes.
Okay, what are you doing with your time, Mr. Gatson? I know we're all stuck inside. I know I just heard from one of our participants, they finally broke down and had to get cable. What are you doing with your time?
I just try to occupy the kids.
Okay.
Try to occupy them, make them do little things. And then the oldest one, I sometimes help them with schoolwork.
Okay.
Stuff like that.
And is the school age one on break right now?
Yeah, they still on break. I don't think they're going back to next year.
No, I would say that's probably a pretty accurate assessment, Mr. Gatson, that's for sure. What about the younger kid?
I try to do little things with them, play little toys or something. Try to let them go outside for a little bit out back, at the back of the house, and play for a little bit, get some energy out.
Yeah, that's for sure. Otherwise, they're climbing around on everything, right?
Definitely.
That's right. So, so again, I know you and I've had many conversations, Mr. Gadsden. You're doing well with us, and we certainly, from probation's perspective, the court's perspective, have no issues. All right. And my concern is for you and your family. You know, what's going on, how treatment is going, and any work situation. I know a lot of people got laid off. I mean, I just heard the news this morning.
Yeah. Yeah, we
22 million people.
Yeah, we just got my job. They told us they had shut our building down. Just
okay. Last week.
Right now, I can't go to. I gotta get another ID, but I can't go to the DMV. But somebody was just telling me I could go online and get another ID offline. He said you go online and try to get an ID. So I try to get another one. I try to go. He's my a close friend of mine. He worked at a little tree house warehouse. He told me
okay.
people still there working. He said just come up there. But I gotta get an ID offline. I'm waiting.
Yeah, well, see what you can do. See if you can go on the Motor Vehicle Commission website and see what you can do. Because I was reading that they were making certain changes and certain accommodations because they don't have the buildings open like usual. So yeah, check that out and let Mr. Griffin know, and he'll let me know, and we can talk about it next time we get together. All right?
Okay.
All right. You anything else you want me to be aware of, Mr. Gadsden?
Now that's it. That's it.
All right. Well, again, I'm going to be saying this a lot today, but it is heartfelt from me, and I know it is from everybody else on the team. We wish you the best. All right. We know this is a challenging time for everybody. People losing jobs and kind of being cooped up in situations.
Get that, Mom.
But if you need any help. You need any assistance, whether it's through treatment, through probation, or through the court, you can reach out to Mr. Griffin. He'll let us know what your situation is, and we'll put our heads together and see if we can help you out, all right?
Okay.
Mr. Gadsden, I wish you and your family the best. You need anything and we can help you, please let us know, all right?
Okay.
I appreciate your time this morning. Keep up the good work, okay?
You too.
Thank you, sir.
All right.
Ron, is there anybody else in the queue?
No, I have no other participants checked in at this time.
Oh, okay, I got a voicemail from Kenneth Johnson, so I'm going to reach out to him. All the clients are familiar with this app, so I don't know why they're not in now, but I'm going to mute and I'm going to contact them right now.
Yeah, Mr. Griffin, and I'll say this. I would like to state for the record, I am cognizant and aware as to how on top of this you are, and you know, from reviewing your submissions as well as everybody else, I also recognize from my lengthy tenure in courtrooms that sometimes individuals either oversleep, forget their responsibilities, even though I'm sure you have reviewed them with them multiple times in anticipation of today. I expected this, candidly. Again, of course, I look at Miss Maureen and she's got a smile on her face, because we all recognize that even coming to court on time sometimes is a challenge, Mr. Griffin. So we recognize this represents some unique challenges. So do what you need to do, and whoever we can connect with, we will. Okay.
We'll do, Judge. I'll
thank you, sir. Maureen. I appreciate it.
Thank you, Judge.
And I know we had a couple pre-programmed people. And I don't know whether we're going to be able to connect with Ms. Hughes, Mr. Chin.
I believe he's in, Judge.
All right. Mr. Laster? I see Mr. Pellicero, too. Yeah. I have Mr. Pellicero on the screen. Mr. Pellicero, can you hear me, sir?
Yes. Hold on 1 second. Let me switch this thing.
Mr. Potash, since I'm actually connected with Mr. Pelichero, I'm going to chat with him. He's one of Mr. Griffin's morning participants, okay?
Very good.
And then if Mr. Laster, one of the Mr. Lasters is there, I'll chat with him next. Mr. Pelichero, you getting yourself settled?
Yeah. I'm trying to... Oh, my God. And now my cat's going to come and just get on me on the screen.
All That's right, okay. There you go. These are the challenges that we're facing. I'm in a bedroom in my house here. So got my robe on, ready to go this morning. So, Mr. Pelichero, how are you doing?
I'm good. You know what I actually picture? Like the stupid stuff that I watch. I see you on the screen, and like a funny show. You have on the robe on the top, and then you picture like a show where he's got like a nice thing on top on the screen, and then like under that you have on just like underwear.
Well, I wouldn't go quite that far, but it's not to say I can assure you that I'm not wearing the customary dress pants and shoes that I normally would. So it's a pretty good guess, Mr. Pelichero.
Other than that, I'm good though. I'm good.
Tell me what's going on. Yeah.
I had the surgery. I haven't seen you since that, I don't think.
No, I have not. How'd that go? Obviously,
good. I'm good. The outside's healed, done healed. It's the inside that's like slowly, you know, I can lift. I can probably run around, but it's, you know, it's still like, just take it easy. Like,
did they put mesh in you?
Yeah, it's some new type of mesh, something that he said it's not the ones you see like on the commercial. You know what I mean? Everybody's suing for and all that crazy.
Right. Let's hope we've moved beyond that for you.
I know. And it's crazy because, like, I've been having so many issues with the friggin' doctor and the surgeon, just, like, talking to him about it. And I keep getting, like, these little sicknesses. It's weird. I'm, like, so we're trying to figure out what it is, like, taking my Suboxone normal, just, I don't know, okay. Just trying to make sure, you know, everything is healthy, health-wise, like, I'm normal, you know?
Yeah. Well, I mean, as long as you're staying in touch with them and keeping them apprised of whatever you're going through. But my brother had the same surgery as you did. I was there with him. I know what happened. I know what the procedure is. So, and yeah, it's, you know, it takes some time to get yourself back to, you know, you just don't want to lift too much and risk hurting
yourself.
Too fast.
Yeah.
So tell me what else is going on. Have you been compliant and going to your sessions with Solstice?
Yeah. At first it was like a little bit of craziness, like going back and forth, getting a hold of each other. But other than that, like now everything is the Zoom things, you know, just signing on and it's easy.
Yeah. Well, when you have somebody who's moderating it, that's doing a good job, at least from my perspective, all I'm doing is now hitting a link, you know, when I get an email.
Exactly. At first it was like, she thinks I'm just not signing into group. You know what I mean? It's not like that. Like I'm trying to get in, but I can hear you, but I can't hear you. And the freaking thing's going on. And now it's like, you know, I'm getting the app, play with the app a little bit. You know, get the
good.
Sister or something. It's funny.
So what's it like, being where you are kind of cooped up all day?
I mean, honestly, it doesn't really bother me. We just ordered an Xbox online. We're going to go pick it up.
Excellent.
Something to do. I mean, we kind of just will Uber eat a little bit, you know what I mean, to get out of the house. As long as you're in by 8, like, from what I see, they don't really bother you, you know what I mean? Like, the cops are not going to bother you, you know what I mean?
No, I agree. That seems to be the case. And, you know, I think that there are all kinds of diversions that people are using. You know, my daughter's playing a game called Roblox and, you know, I've got my old school PS4 down here. And so, doing puzzles and all the rest.
It's stupid stuff.
It's a challenge, that's for sure. But you're doing okay physically. You're doing okay mentally.
Absolutely. Yeah, I'm good.
Good. Well, I can say because I have, and I'll just hold this up. I get comprehensive reviews on everybody, Mr. Pelichero. So part of my job is, absorbing the information and discussing what I think is relevant. But, you know, I'm glad you got the issues worked out with Solstice. I'm happy that, that your procedure went well. You seem like you're doing well. Okay. Yes. So, if you need anything, I'm repeating myself kind of to everybody. If you need anything, you're struggling for some reason, you got an issue, you know who to reach out to. You can reach out to Mr. Griffin, you can reach out to counsel, you know, and we'll do what we can to put you in the best position. But it seems like you're doing well, all right?
Absolutely. Thank you. Thank you.
All right. So keep up the good work, Mr. Pelletier. It's good to see you. All right.
Okay. You too. Now, how do I, do I stay in this for the whole thing or just leave?
No, I have thought that once I've talked to a participant, rather than you sitting in the courtroom like you would normally do, unless I let you go, yeah. I don't think it's appropriate for you to have to sit here until I talk to everybody all day. So whoever I talk to in whatever order, you are done, okay?
All right, cool. Thank you. Have a good one, guys.
All right, take care of yourself. Okay, I see several other participants with us. Did we have Lamont Laster? Was he there? All right, or Kenneth Johnson. Or Junior Laster. It does not appear that we do. And Mr. Griffin, I know you're working assiduously to try and to reel in some of our participants. and again, I'm pretty flexible here, and this goes to for all of the senior probation officers. I'm pretty flexible here. I'm relying on Mr. Potash to patch in and patch us out. But I mean, I see Ms. Zitnik, I see Mr. Morgan, I see Ms. Kammerer. So I'm gonna kind of move on and address some of these other matters because they're waiting. And so, all right, Mr. Dickey, I see you on the screen and you are muted, but I see several of your participants here. So I'm going to go kind of in the order that I see them on my screen. All right, so Ms. Zitnik, you are to my left. So I'm going to talk to you first. Good morning. How are you doing?
Good morning. How are you?
I'm doing okay. What's happening with you, Ms. Zitnik?
Nothing much. I'm just still trying to, you know, live life like I used to. I'm still, well, I'm out of work right now, but hopefully once all this gets situated, I can go back to work.
Yeah, I had read the information that was provided to me by Mr. Dickey about the job. And again, I'm going to say to you the same thing I've said to a lot of other people already this morning. This is the reality now. We know that you want to work. We had, encouraged you to work. You had gotten a job. And so it has nothing to do with you and it's not your fault. And our expectation is that, you know, once things change, you'll go back to doing what you're doing. Okay.
Yeah.
Did you complete treatment?
Yes, I did.
Congratulations. That's fantastic. So what are you doing with your time now? Tell me what's going on.
Well, I've been attending some of the meetings online.
Okay.
Just to keep me busy. I've been in touch with my sponsor. And I'm just doing some stuff around the house now just to, you know, stay busy.
Okay. All right. Anything in particular you're doing around the house? Painting? Or
a lot of painting. Finally got the paint gun.
Good, 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 good. All right. So you're being productive at home. You feeling okay generally?
Yeah, I feel great.
All right. Fantastic. Well, I got all this good information and I knew, I did know that you had completed, some probably 6 weeks ago now or something like that.
Yeah, but, it's been a little while.
Yeah, but I commend you for continuing to engage in sessions otherwise. You're doing well, and I expect that you're going to continue to do well, okay? So, again, if you need any help, anything, you reach out to Mr. Dickey, you can reach out to Ms. Moraine, and we'll do what we can to keep you in the best possible position during these times that are really trying for everybody. You know, it really is difficult for everyone, but you look well, you sound like you're doing well, so I commend you. Keep up the good work, okay?
Thank you.
All right. You have anything else from me, Ms. Zitnik?
No, that's it.
All right. Keep us posted on any changes, okay? Otherwise, you have a nice day, all right?
And okay, thank you, too.
You're free to log off and free to go. Enjoy your day, all right?
Thank you, too.
Thank you. All right. I'm going to move on to Mr. Morgan. Mr. Morgan. Mr. Morgan, can you hear me? Mr. Morgan looks like he's wandering around. Mr. Morgan, can you hear me, sir? Can you hear me? All right, I don't know what's going on with Mr. Morgan. Ms. Kammerer, can you hear me? I think Ms. Kammerer can hear me. She looks like she's muted. Ms. Kammerer, I think you are muted. I'm not sure if you can control that, Mr. Potash, or Ms. Kammerer can.
Can you hear me?
I can hear you now, Ms. Kammerer. How are you?
I'm good. How about you?
I'm doing fine. Thank you. Tell me what's going on with you.
I've just been working a lot. Just got out of the Hanson House about a month ago today, actually.
Yeah. What was your experience like at Hanson House?
I mean, I liked it. I did.
Yeah, I want you to be like honest really with me. Good. Yeah. Tell me, what do you think the best part of it was, and why it was good for you?
Because I never really worked before, so it, like, they made me work.
Okay.
I built, like, a work ethic.
Good. And tell me about work. What's happening with work?
I work at Harris Tea in Morristown. I just package tea. Like, I put tea boxes in a bigger box and then okay. It shipped out.
And you're still working, right?
Yes.
Okay. How often are you working? Working every day, a couple days a week? What's the deal?
Yeah, I get 40 hours a week. It's okay. Monday through Friday. It's 9 p.m. to 5 in the morning.
Okay. All right. So you're gonna go to work later on today, is that right?
Yes. But I have solstice today too at 2 to 5.
You got solstice 2 to 5. So yeah, so you've got other stuff going on, because that's what I was going to ask about solstice. You're able to link up telephonically, is that right?
Yes, but sometimes I go in to the group.
Okay. All right. I didn't know that that was that was something that you were able to do. So sometimes you're doing it in person, and sometimes you are doing it like over Zoom, like we're doing now.
Yes.
Okay. All right. Well, again, I'm going to try and talk to all of the phase one and most of the phase two participants this morning. And so is there anything else that you think we should know about? Anything of note or interest going on in your life?
Well, today I have a year clean.
Congratulations. That's fantastic. That is absolutely wonderful. Congratulations. And, you know, you deserve and you've earned all these positive things that are now happening in your life, Ms. Kammerer. So I commend you. You keep up the good work. If there's anything any of us can do to put you in a better position, you let us know. We're here to help you, okay?
Okay, thank you.
All right. Enjoy your time at Solstice. And again, I think you are enjoying your time at work despite the hours. So keep up the good work. Okay, Ms. Kammerer. And we'll talk again soon. Okay.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Mr. Morgan, can you hear me? Mr. Morgan, can you hear me, sir? I don't think Mr. Morgan can hear me, because I see him. I don't really know what to say other than maybe he's not connected via internet audio, because that sometimes happens. So, Mr. Morgan, hang in there.
Hey. Judge, I'll give him a call right now. We'll see if I can get him up online.
Thank you. Is that Mr. Chambers smoking there?
Yeah, that's a black and mild, Mr.
Most people call me Judge, Mr. Chambers. Good morning. How are you today?
All right.
What's going on with you, sir?
I'm working.
Okay, are you still working?
Yes, I am working at KFC on Route 130 in Willenboro.
Yeah, those were the notes that I had, Mr. Chambers. And as I know from talking to other people this morning, sometimes people working in that industry, they've closed down. Other people have continued to work. So you're in a fortunate position. You're continuing to work. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, that's good. What else is going on with you?
I'm staying out of trouble, for one.
Good.
I'm drug free, alcohol Excellent. Free.
Okay.
I'm everything free. I'm staying on my pivot. Like I ain't letting this discourage me or nothing.
Okay. Just
doing what I'm supposed to do.
Good. Well, I'm happy to hear that, Mr. Chambers. I think this might be the most pleasant and interactive conversation you and I've had over a very long time, and I appreciate it. I appreciate the fact that you're talking to me like I'm a person, you know, we're here to help you. So I'm happy that you're working, you're continuing to do well. Your family, everybody okay in your family?
Yeah, my mom, she down south, and my aunt and them just called me and told me that she was sick, so.
Okay. All right.
So,
well, my thoughts and prayers will be with your family as well, Mr. Chambers, because again, this is a difficult time for everybody. You're feeling okay, and everybody in your household is okay?
Yes, yes, yes. Everybody's healthy in my household.
Okay, good. Fantastic. Well, I'll say this, Mr. Chambers, I appreciate your time. I appreciate the fact that, as you've indicated to me, you know, no new charges, clean, you're working, no issues. I commend you, Mr. Chambers. Please keep up the good work, and I look forward to talking to you again, okay?
All right, thank you, sir.
You have a nice day. Thanks for your time.
All right.
All right, Mr. Spencer.
Hey, how are you, Judge Garrenger?
I'm doing well, Mr. Spencer. How are you today? Did I lose you, Mr. Spencer? Well, that was a short-lived conversation with Mr. Spencer. I don't know if we can bring him back, but that's okay. Mr. Morgan, can you hear me? I'm not sure that Mr. Morgan can hear me. So I see Mr. Temistockle on the screen.
Yes, how you doing, Judge?
Mr. Temistockle, good morning. How are you? I'm doing fine. I'm sitting
here doing
in my robe in my house, and you look slightly more comfortable in your attire wherever you are. tell me what's going on.
Nothing. I just, you know, I have my own business, so I just been selling a lot of CMOS. Actually, my business actually been doing better since this situation.
Yeah, I was reading the information that was sent to me by Mr. Dickey, and of course it piqued my interest because I didn't understand what CMOS was, and I was gonna ask you about
it. It's also called Irish moss, and it's like a nutrient. It actually helps your immune system, and it kills mucus, and it does a lot of different things, like it cleans your cells out, and like people always taking it, but it's becoming a little popular now because like more people are becoming into holistic things instead of using like traditional medicine.
Sure.
So I started taking it because I had high blood pressure, and I was like borderline diabetic, and it helped me a lot. So I started selling it because I couldn't get a hold of it enough. So
what form does it come in? Is it like a capsule?
It's like a vegetation. It comes raw. It comes out the ocean.
Okay. All right. And so
I turn it into a I either sell it like that as is, or I sell it into a gel, or I turn it into capsules.
Okay. All right. That's very interesting. I started practicing as a lawyer, I had a nutraceutical company, which didn't work out that well, because I ended up doing other stuff. But you know, as a member of the Institute of Food Technologists, which I am, I was very interested. And I am very interested to hear about this and the beneficial qualities. So we can continue this conversation on another day, Mr. Temistocle. All right. So tell me what else is happening other than that. You are attending Legacy as well, is that right?
Yes, I attend the Legacy twice a week.
Okay. Fantastic. Yeah. And that's been okay for you as well?
Yeah, it's been very good. Everything's good with that.
All right. What about your family and what about your health situation and them? Everybody okay?
Yeah, everybody's okay. Everybody was staying home. Everybody, you know, just trying to dodge the situation, because you know, I live with a lot of older people, and you know, they're basically like, stay home, because I'm more worried about them getting it than me. So,
yeah, I agree with you. We are younger and relatively healthy. I get it. So yeah, so we'll continue doing what you're doing, Mr. Temistocle. I was very pleased to get the performance reviews by Mr. Dickey saying that you're doing well. Okay, so. All right. I'm sure you got other stuff to do. Enjoy your day. We're going to terminate our portion of the conversation. You don't have to stay on, and you're free to go, okay?
All right. Thank you. Have a nice day, Joe.
You too, Mr. Temistocle. Take care. Thank you.
All right. Judge, Mr. Spencer's back in.
All right.
Can you hear me?
Mr. Spencer.
Yes, sir. Sorry about that. I don't know what happened.
Oh, it's okay. As long as you're here with us, what's going on? You're doing all right?
Yes, sir. I'm very good.
Fantastic. How are you feeling? How's your family feeling?
Everybody's good.
Okay. All right. Go ahead. I didn't mean to interrupt you.
No, I said everybody's good that I know of.
All right. Fantastic. I'm looking at my notes, which are relatively brief. We know that you completed treatment at Legacy back in March, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, what are you doing with yourself now? What are you doing with your time?
Just working and trying to stay away from people so I don't get sick.
Yeah, I'm with you. Have you been working every day still?
No, I went. My job was a little sketchy for a while. There was a couple sick people there, so he let us distance ourselves, and then in the process, I got a better job.
Okay,
so
things worked out for you, Mr. Spencer.
Yeah, a little bit, man. Just doing online Zoom NA meetings.
Okay. All right. And you feel like things are working for you?
Yeah, I think everything's going great.
Yeah, fantastic. Well, I definitely have gotten some good reviews, Mr. Spencer, and I'm happy to talk to you. Any challenges specifically, or everything seems to be generally okay?
Yeah, I got one challenge. I can't get a haircut. I'm going crazy here. I need a haircut more than anything, and I can't get one.
Yeah, I could have sworn I had some clippers around here somewhere. I cannot find them because I was encouraging my wife and my daughter to play spa on me, because I can't take my hair either. It's out of control. But maybe they hid the clippers. I don't know. I don't know if that's what happened or what. But that's a challenge for a lot of us, Mr. Spencer.
Yeah, if I could have one thing right now, that would be it. Just a haircut.
There you go. Well, I will say this, Mr. Spencer, you're doing well. I greatly appreciate your time and your interaction with us this morning. We're going to try and continue this mode and method as we move forward, and we appreciate your ability to link up with us. And unless you have anything further for us, I would say I hope you have a great day and continue the good work. Okay.
Thank you, sir. You too.
All right. Thank you, Mr. Spencer. We'll disconnect with you, and you have a great day. All right.
Thanks, Judge Garrenger. You too.
Thank you, sir.
Bye-bye.
I'm going to try and say hello to Mr. Morgan again. And if I can't say hi to Mr. Morgan, can you hear me? Still don't think he can hear me. So I'm going to talk to Ms. Schneider, because I see her.
Hello.
Ms. Schneider, good morning.
Good morning. How are you?
I'm doing fine. How are you doing?
I'm doing well. Thank you.
Nice. You're looking well. What's going on with you?
Nothing much. Just spending a lot of time with my kids, doing a Bible study in church over the internet, and some yard work and staying busy.
So you were able to get outside a little bit and do some yard work and stuff like that, right?
And walking and stuff.
Okay. Kids
too cooped up.
Yeah. How are the kids making out?
They're doing good. My son's teaching me how to ride his dirt bike.
Okay.
So that's been fun and challenging.
Keep your helmet. Keep the helmet on.
Yeah, exactly.
And what else is happening?
Nothing much. Oh, I'm doing the telehealth through Oaks Integrated. So
yeah, I was going to ask you about that. So yeah, thank you.
Yeah, when we get off the phone, I'm going to go up there and take a drug test. I do that once a week.
Okay.
So
nice. Nice. Yeah, and again, I get very comprehensive information about every one of our participants. And I say all the time, I don't share a lot of it publicly because really it's not anybody else's business. But the information I get pertaining to you, Ms. Schneider, is good. Okay. And you look like you're in a good place right now. I know this is stressful for everybody, you know, and I had some real concerns, of course, as did all of the supervising officers, all the attorneys, everybody on the drug court team, because of this great external pressure, you know, and how people were going to react to it. And I have to say that some people have reacted to it marvelously. It seems like you're doing really well. Okay. So I commend you. If there's anything we can do to put you in a better position to help you out in any way, you let us know. All right.
Will do. Thanks.
Okay. All right. Well, we're going to let you go so you can address what you have to at Oaks Integrated. Okay. And again, thank you for your time this morning. We appreciate it. And we'll talk to you soon. Okay.
Have a good day.
You as well, Ms. Schneider. Thank you. Is that Mr. Campbell down there?
Yes.
Mr. Campbell, how are you today?
Good. How are you, Judge?
I'm doing fine. What is happening? Are you still working?
Yeah. Not a lot of hours, but yeah, I still get to clean up at night every night. So yeah, I'm still working.
Yeah, because I just wasn't sure if the place was still open, and if they were, whether they were doing, you know, whether they had maintained your position. So, but you're doing okay?
Yeah. Yes.
All right. What's going on with you? Otherwise, well, I mean, I know you're at Genesis, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Tell me what's happening with that.
Well, like I have the one-on-ones over the phone with Sarah. Usually it was once a week, but she's been calling twice a week, like just to check in on me. And,
good. She's a Friday, very responsible person.
Yeah. And, Friday I went and did a mouth swab. I was like in and out. It took like 2 seconds.
Okay. All right. Good. So you're working a couple days a week at this point?
Yeah. Like 4 days a week.
Okay. And what are you doing with your free time otherwise? How are you occupying your time? What are you doing?
Well, I go between my mom's house and my daughter's house, but my mom doesn't like me leaving too much. So I pretty much just do work and see my daughter and stay home.
Okay. All right. But you're feeling all right. Things, your family's okay. Your mom's okay. Your daughter's okay.
Yeah. Everybody's okay.
All right. So when's the next time you work? You working tonight?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Yep. And what about treatment? You said it's been telephonically. When do you expect you're going to talk to Sarah again?
Probably today.
Okay.
It's always Saturday. Saturday's the scheduled one, but then she calls during the week to check on me.
All right. Well, when you talk to her, tell her I said thank you for checking up on you. All right, Mr. Campbell?
All right.
All right. Look, I wish you and your family the best. You know, I'm going to be hoarse from repeating myself all morning. But look, these are unique times. If you're struggling, you have any problems or issues, which you don't seem to, you let us know. We'll put you in the best position we can because we want you to be a success and we want you to make it through all this stuff. Okay, Mr. Campbell?
Right. Thank you.
All right. I appreciate your time. You have a nice day, okay?
All right. You too.
Thank you, sir. All right. I do see, once again, Mr. Morgan. I know he's been on for a while. Mr. Morgan, can you hear me? Because he's on mute now again. Mr. Morgan, can I hear? I still can't. You can hear me. I cannot hear you, but that's okay. Mr. Morgan, I'm going to ask you a couple questions, all right? And you can nod your head yes or no.
Judge, you want me to bring him in through speakerphone, through my microphone here?
If it's not unreasonable for you to do so, Mr. Dickey, that would be okay.
All right, he's present. You're with the judge, Mr. Morgan.
Yes.
Mr. Morgan, good morning. How are you?
I'm okay, sir.
Good. It's good to talk to you. I keep seeing you on the screen, but I haven't been able to get the audio hooked up. And sometimes there's an extra step to hook up to the audio that's even confused me at points. But I just want to talk to you, see how you're doing. What's going on, Mr. Morgan?
I'm doing great. Me and the family, we have 13 in ourselves, and I've been in the house about a month now. My backyard is the most
beautiful
yard you can
want to
look at.
And I'm like, they're like, oh, that's different. You're not old.
Hello?
How are you doing? Iron Chin?
Yeah, Mr. Chin, we'll be with you in a second, okay? We're gonna put you on mute because I was talking to Mr. Morgan. So, Mr.
All right,
Morgan,
I apologize.
No worries. Mr. Morgan, you completed Unity back in the end of March, is that right? Yeah, the information that I got is all good, Mr. Morgan. You're compliant, and we're not having any issues. Hey, Mr. Dickey. Since I'm having some difficulty again talking to Mr. Morgan, is he still there?
Yeah, he's still here, Judge.
All right, Mr. Morgan, it's true that you completed your time at Unity back in March. Is that right?
Yes, I did, sir.
Congratulations. And you said you've been cooped up in the house for like a month. Is that what I heard you say?
Yes, like a month.
Yeah, me too. I've only left three times to go to the grocery store and one time to drive to Mount Holly to get my work computer fixed. So what are you doing inside your house? What are you doing with your time?
Doing the backyard, doing my backyard, helping my mom with herself.
Okay.
And that's the way it goes. That's my process.
All right. Well, everybody's healthy. Is that right?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
All right. Good. Well, here's the deal, Mr. Morgan. I've got plenty to talk to you about, but I know that we're having some communication difficulties, so we'll have a more extended conversation next time we talk. I've read the reviews that Mr. Dickey has provided to me, and they indicate that you're doing really well, all right? So I commend you. I want you to keep up the good work that you're doing, all right? If you need any assistance in any way, of course, Mr. Dickey's the point person, Miss Moraine, myself, any of us. So keep working on the backyard, keep taking care of the family, all right? And we'll talk to you soon, okay, Mr. Morgan?
Thank you, Mr. All right.
All right. I appreciate you. I hope you have a good day. Thank you.
You too.
Thank you, sir. All right, I had Mr. Chin on here before. So I can chat with Mr. Chin real quick. Mr. Chin is a pre-programmed individual. Mr. Chin, can you hear me?
Yes.
How you doing today?
I'm doing good today. Today's my birthday, actually.
Today's your birthday, the day after tax day. Well, happy birthday, Mr. Chin. How old are you today?
22.
22. Wow. 22 years old. I remember those days. Quite a while ago for me now. How you feeling? All right?
I'm feeling all right. How are you?
I'm doing fine. Thank you. Yeah, I'm here in my house with my wife and my daughter. We've been locked down for basically a month, like a lot of other people. So it has its challenges, but, you know, I feel like I'm lucky and I'm blessed. What's going on with you, Mr. Chin? I know we had some issues in the beginning, but it's my understanding that you've been attending treatment sessions. Is that right?
Yes, I have. I had I just was unclear that we had to do two separate sessions with the individual and the group. I was only doing the group. So now I got that clarified. I actually had to switch counselors because of my cousin was in the same group. So I got a new counselor. I just got off the phone with her. So I'm going to be doing my individual group with her today at 1 o'clock.
Fantastic. All right. So it sounds like you're on top of things, Mr. Chin. That's good because I had some emails that were sent to me that had some concerns in them, but it sounds like everything's straightened out. That's fantastic.
Yes.
What's going on with you at home? How's your family doing?
We're doing all right. I just been staying in the house, but I did have a job interview yesterday at Amazon. So hopefully I should be starting there May 2nd.
Oh, that would be fantastic. Another step in the right direction, certainly, Mr. Chin. So that's great.
Yeah, I got the overnight shift, so it works around everything I still need to do. So,
okay,
hopefully everything should work out.
All right. Well, I'm saying this to everybody. If there's anything that we can do to put you in a better position to help you out, you let us know. Okay. I know that Ms. Marine is working hard on trying to address that one other matter that's hanging out there. Okay. And so we're going to try and get all that stuff done, as quickly as we reasonably can. But I'm happy to hear that everything's on track with you, Mr. Chin, and keep up the good work. And again, Ms. Marine's a point person. You know Mr. Tomlin you've been talking to. So any of us, we're all here for you, okay, Mr. Chin?
Thank you. I appreciate that.
All right. Keep us posted on the job and anything else, all right?
All right. I will.
My best to your family. Have a nice day.
Thank you. Judge, we can leave.
Oh, hold on a second.
Judge, before we release Mr. Chin from today's court session, I believe the order is ready to go. We just needed to place on the record Mr. Chin's non-objection to the change of venue for the Camden matter.
All right, Mr. Chin, and I briefly discussed this matter with your attorney, Ms. Moraine, who is present. They've drafted an order, okay, moving your matter from Camden County to Burlington County, all right? And there are separate court rules that deal with this. There's a consolidation rule and a change of venue rule, okay? And in a consolidation or a change of venue, and here this is technically, for whatever reason, a change of venue, which again, I can devolve into and give my opinion, which I'm not going to do. But in any event, it's characterized broadly as a change of venue. You have the right to have a hearing on the matter if you were somehow to object to the concept of having the matter moved from Camden to Burlington for disposition. I think you recognize that the goal is to resolve that matter and have you in drug court. Now, I'm asking you whether you would want to exercise your right to have a hearing on the change of venue, or that you would agree to the change of venue and waive any hearing. Do you understand what I'm asking?
Yes,
you agree to the change and you waive any hearing. All right.
Yes.
Very good, Mr. Chin. I think that's the most efficient and expeditious way we can proceed. So Ms. Moraine is here and has heard this, and I know Mr. Potash has as well. So now, Mr. Chin, we're going to let you go. Do your thing. Keep up the good work. We'll talk soon, okay?
Thank you. Y'all have a good one. Okay, and when's the next time we have to do this?
I'm not sure if we're going to be doing it again in 1 week from today on Thursday. I'm going to confer with the team because this is the first time that we're actually able to reasonably accomplish this. And for the phase one people, certainly, and you're pre-programmed still, for the phase one people, I'm pretty sure I am going to do this next week, a week from today. Thursday, okay? But we'll keep you posted. Don't you worry, all right, Mr.
All right, thank you so much.
All right, thank you for your time.
All right, you too. Have a great day.
You too. Is that Mr. Laster?
Sure.
Mr. Laster, how are you?
How you doing?
That's a fancy car you got.
Yeah, I get service out here. I'm gonna service inside, so I can come.
No, that's okay.
Solstice out here too in the car because I don't get good service.
Hey, yeah, no, I can go around in my house and have no service. Right? Yeah, no service in one room and you know, four bars in another room, right?
Yeah.
So what's going on with you, Mr. Laster?
Oh, nothing. Just stressful times. Just trying to deal with everything that's going on. It's really crazy. Then I had my cousin, she has the virus, and we were like all together for my aunt's birthday. It was just like immediate family, but then like a week after that, we found out she was sick. So everybody's on edge. Like my mom, I can't even go visit my mom. She don't want nobody around. It's just really crazy right now.
Yeah, no, and it's understandable too. I mean, you're a relatively young, healthy dude.
Yeah, my son, like every day now. Because he's not in school, and it's like I feel fine, but you know, I don't know how that thing works out, and I would kill me if he got sick because of me. Like, it's just crazy.
Absolutely, yeah. That's why I haven't seen and had any contact with my parents or my brother. My brother's really one of the closest people in my life. Haven't had any personal contact with them in a month for the very same reason, you know. So it's tough for all of us.
I was saying, like, I was talking to people, like, I don't know nobody that got this. I never heard of nobody that knows somebody that got it, except for like people in group talk about somebody, a family member way down somewhere. Then all of a sudden, this is like hit right home. Like it's just crazy. I don't know. It's just
yeah.
Crazy.
Yeah. Well, I know that you had some issues at Solstice, right? You know, and again, we're not going to get into it now. All right. All I want to say is this, is that I do recognize exactly what you're saying, that, these are pretty much the most stressful times that people are going to have. You know, this is something that's totally beyond any of our control. And, it's been a massive change of lifestyle for everybody, you know? And again, separation from loved ones and trying to deal with concerns. You know, I've got an 8-year-old she's not 8 anymore. She's 10 years old now. And she's asking me all kinds of questions about, like, you know, what's going on? How long is this going to keep up? When am I going to go back to school? Am I going back to school? You know,
He wants to go back to school, like, can't.
And these are questions, you know, as adults and mentors to our kids that we can't really answer. And I have to say, it stresses me out too. I'm a pretty mellow guy, and I get stressed out because I'm like, geez, how do I reasonably answer a valid question from a kid, you know, and when we don't know the answers, you know? So look, you're not the only one going through this stressful stuff. My concern is, of course, what your reactions to these things are. Okay. So, my question for you is, when are you linking up with Solstice again?
I do it online, you know, every, Monday, Tuesday, and Saturday.
Okay, so tomorrow would be, Thursday, Saturday.
Yeah.
All right, so what are you going to do with the rest of your day, Mr. Laster?
Oh, well, my son's, they don't got no, I got my son every day because he don't have no schoolwork this week, so
yeah.
I got him with me while his mom's working, and he usually go to his aunt's and does schoolwork there, but he's with me this week, so.
All right, what are you going to do with him?
Whatever. All he wants to do is ride bikes, so we'd be outside riding bikes.
All right, cool. Well, just keep your social distance away from anybody else who's out there riding their bikes, okay? And
yeah.
Good, 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 good. Well, Mr. Lasher, I'll tell you this. You know, I'm not going to get into the other stuff right now. I'm going to offer again assistance from all of us. Okay, if there's anything that we can do to put you in a better position, you know, make things easier for you, address any issues, let us know. We'll do what we can to assist you. Okay.
Yeah, I'm just really having a hard time finding a job now. Like everything's closed down, and I put in. I know I had a long history of not working, so I don't know if that's why I'm not getting kickbacks. But I guess it could be with everything that's going on too. I don't know. It just would really help if I could find a job. Like, I'm getting starting to get cabin fever right now with this whole situation.
Look, I understand, and as I said to you know, one of the first people I talked to this morning, I do recognize that you know, there are 22 million unemployment claims in the last 4 weeks. So, you know, I think things are going to change moving forward, but right now, you know, anybody that's been able to maintain their employment has kind of been surprising to me, who are participants, because, you know, Burlington Coat Factory will close, or, you know, types of restaurants or whatever. So I get it. I if we can help you, you know, you can reach out to Mr. Dickey, you can reach out to Miss Maureen. If we can think of something, or any other participants are like, hey, I got a spot here and we're still working, we'll let you know, okay?
Yep.
Okay. Well, I hope you take care of yourself. My best to your family. All right. And we'll talk again soon. All right, Mr. Lester?
All right, Joe.
Thank you for your time. You have a good day.
Thank you. You too.
Thank you, sir. All right. So.
Are we supposed to say something to you so you know we're here?
I've got a whole bunch of people on the screen right now. Okay. So I am going to, because I had some people from the morning list that I didn't speak to yet, and if they're not there, I'm just going to move on. I know Tyrone Glenn, Mr. Glenn is not there. Kenneth Johnson, Junior Laster.
I'm here.
There you are, Mr. Laster. You're down in my corner screen. Lester, how are you today?
I'm all right. The link was messed. I had to come to go. I got it though.
Okay. All right. So now you're here with us. Okay. I got a couple questions for you. First one is how you're doing and how's your family doing?
We all right. Just going through the changes in life. It's all right though.
Okay. All right. I know that you made up some sessions at Solstice, right?
Yeah. Yep.
Okay. And everything's straightened out there? Everything okay there?
Yep. Everything's fantastic. I'm doing what I got to do. Staying focused.
That I am aware of. You're, you know, your negative drug screens and... you know, you're doing what you're supposed to do, Mr. Laster. So what does today hold for you, Junior Laster? What are you doing with the rest of your day once you disconnect from me?
I really don't. It's really nothing nobody can really do because you're really not allowed out in society. I mean, else you're just going to get something to eat or something.
Right.
I'll probably just sit around the house.
Okay. You got any projects that you can work on at the house?
I do music and stuff like that. But
okay,
you know what I mean, like I don't know. I'm just like pretty much doing the social distance thing. I'm just trying not to catch that flu type thing.
Oh. Look, I agree with you, and that's, of course, why we're all doing this, you know, via Zoom rather than packing ourselves into the courtroom, you know? So, you're healthy. You seem like everything's going okay. So I don't have a whole lot for you, Mr. Laster, other than I'm glad we could connect this morning, okay? Yes. And I offer the same help always, you know, if there's anything that we can do, if you're struggling with something. But you seem to be on top of things, Mr. Laster. So, you know, keep doing what you're doing. If we can help you out in any way, please let us know, all right?
All right. Thanks a lot, sir.
All right. Well, I hope you have a great day, Mr. Laster. Take care of yourself.
You too, sir. Stay away from that corona, man.
That's right. Exactly. That's what I'm doing. All right. Take care. Mr. Dickey, I see you. I have, there are a couple people, because, well, let me go back to Mr. Griffin. I know I'm looking at my watch, trying to keep pace with what we're supposed to be doing here. Mr. Griffin, I'm going to ask you, there were two individuals for the morning session that we weren't able to get, Tyrone Glenn and Kenneth Johnson. Does that continue to be your understanding?
That's correct, Your Honor. I was able to get in touch with both of them on the phone. Problem with Mr. Johnson's email, I just sent him a test email and he got mine. So,
okay.
And I got resubmitted. That might work. Mr. Glenn has internet connection problems. The best solution to that might be Lance's solution, which was calling him on the cell phone and holding it up to the screen.
Okay. All right. Well, again, if it's easier, Mr. Griffin, for you to move those two matters to your afternoon session, because I'm sure you have many other things to address. Why don't we do that? Why don't we ask Mr. Glenn and Mr. Johnson to reconnect? I think you're scheduled with us at 3.
That's correct.
And so we can try it like that if that's okay with you.
Absolutely, Judge.
All right, very good. Well then, Mr. Griffin, I appreciate your efforts, and I'll see you this afternoon. Okay. Thank you. Now, Mr. Dickey, I apologize. Mr. Dickey, we have been able to chat with many of your participants. I have a couple more that I don't know are with us or not.
It looks like they're both with us. We have Adrian, Allison Droney, and then also Jamie Andruska. They look like they're both in session.
Okay.
Hi, Judge.
Aha. Hello.
Hello?
Hello? I'm not sure who I'm talking to because you're not Adrian. On my... Miss Alessandroni?
Yes. How are you?
How are you doing? How are you doing?
I'm great.
Nice. You just recently completed treatment at Epiphany House. Is that right?
Well, yes. I've been away for 6 months.
Yes. That much I know. A lot has changed in 6 months, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, well, and tell me about you. What's going on with you? What are changes with you?
Well, I'm back home with my mom and my daughter, so that's good.
And, remind me, how old's your daughter?
When I was in treatment, 12.
12, okay.
She's 12. She's 12.
All right. Is she in school this week or have break this week?
No, she has break.
Okay. All right. Good. And that would make her what? Seventh grade?
Sixth grade.
Okay. Nice. Very good. She's doing okay?
Yes, she is. She's got, you know, cabin fever like everybody else, but she's okay.
And how's your mom doing?
She's good. She's handicapped, so she doesn't get out much anyway. So I'm just, you know, taking care of her.
All right.
And our house is under construction, so we're getting all kinds of new stuff.
Okay, what kind of construction's going on?
Okay, you got my email, but you didn't get the other one.
Hello?
Hello?
Yeah, what kind of construction you got going on?
They're doing everything. They did the bathroom over, all the bedrooms, every room.
Okay, well, good. What was your experience like at treatment?
I mean, I have to say, obviously, I didn't want to go, but once I was there, you know, I was at Integrity and then Epiphany, and they were both wonderful. So
good. Well, you know, because I always ask and I encourage, you know, our participants to be honest, because, you know, feedback that I get about what goes on in treatment facilities and via treatment providers is important, because, like I said, that information goes from us to the people that are supervising us, the people that, of course, are responsible for, approving and sanctioning the programs here in drug court. So I ask because I'm curious and I want to know what, people's experience has been. And yours, despite the fact, I think what you said is despite the fact that you didn't want to go, it turned out to be valuable for you. Is that correct?
Absolutely.
All right. Nice. So as far as any current treatment, anything that you're involved with right now?
Well, I did IOP while I was at Epiphany House. So that's done.
Okay.
I am going to be doing, NA, get a sponsor, home group, and, just stay with the program, the NA program.
Nice. Well, I'm sure you're happy to be home. These are strange circumstances with, lockdown and social distancing. You're doing okay with that right now?
I am. I'm also on the methadone program, which has been a complete lifesaver.
All right. And that I had neglected to write down, and that's important for me too. So the regimen of medically assisted treatment is working for you, am I right?
Tremendously.
All right, fantastic. Well, I got to say, Miss Alessandroni, you sound wonderful. You sound happy and healthy, and I'm very happy with your progress with us, okay?
Thank you.
All right. So do you have anything else for me this morning?
Nope, I'm good, Judge.
All right. Well, you hang in there. If there's anything we can do to put you in an even better position, you let us know, okay?
All right. Thank you.
I wish you and your family the best. Stay safe, and we'll talk again soon, okay?
Okay, yours as well. Thank you.
Thank you very much. And Mr. Dickey, you also said we had Miss Andruska as well?
Yes, it appears she's in session. It looks like she's muted.
Okay.
Okay. Is that how we do it?
Miss Andruska?
Yes.
Hey, it's Judge Garrett. How are you?
How are you?
I'm hanging in there. How are you doing?
I'm okay.
What's happening?
Just dealing with this being stuck in the house.
Yeah. Well, again, everybody, has different reactions to it. Some people, it's not really a change. Other people, it's a total 180 in their lives. What's it like for you? What's happened?
Just like the school teaching with my son is a little bit difficult sometimes, but
yeah. Why so? Is it the subject matter? Is just actually doing it? What's the difficulty?
Getting him, did you hear me?
Getting him motivated to do it. I'm sorry. Is that what you were saying?
Yeah.
Yeah, no. My daughter is the same thing. She certainly would be rather playing a game than doing her homework. That's for sure.
Yeah, he's definitely always rushing to get on the Xbox.
Yeah, I get it. So, are you still able to attend sessions at Legacy? Is that what's happening?
I do it over the phone.
Okay. All right. And how often are you doing that?
She moved me up to every 2 weeks.
Every 2 weeks. Okay. Yeah. All right. And the living situation right now is okay with you?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Have you been getting out at all or been staying strictly locked down?
I work between like 1 and 2 days a week. Okay. But other than that, don't really get out much just to get grocery shopping.
Yep. Understood. Yeah. All right. Well, I'm glad I got to touch base with you this morning just to see how you were doing. Okay. And as we offer over and over, if there's anything that we as a team can do to help you out, put you in a better position, don't hesitate to let us know. We're here to help you. All right, Ms. Andruska?
All right. Thank you so much.
Well, thank you for your time and thanks for connecting with us this morning. I really appreciate it, okay?
No problem. Thank you.
All right. You have a nice day. Best to your family.
You too.
Thank you. Mr. Dickey, I think that that completes your list for this morning. Am I correct, sir?
Yes, Judge. I appreciate it. Thank you.
All right. Thank you. We'll see you this afternoon. We, and I recognize our individuals on screen. For Mrs. Semptenfelter's matters, I think is how we have this scheduled.
Oh my gosh.
All right, I see Mr. Strickland down there. Mr. Strickland. Mr. Strickland's muted, so hold on a second.
Excuse me.
Yes.
Oh, not you. Sorry. Tell me to be quiet. I'm at court.
Mr. Strickland.
Good morning, sir.
How are you doing today, Mr. Strickland?
I am blessed. I am so blessed, you know. How are you and how's your family?
I appreciate you asking. I'm doing fine, and my family's fine. I think everybody's collectively a little bored, except for me. I got my work to do, but okay. my daughter's on school break, and subsequently driving my wife a little crazy. But that's okay. That's what it's all about.
Yeah, long as they're safe.
Exactly. That's exactly right. We're all happy and we're all healthy, Mr. Strickland. What's going on with you? Are you feeling okay?
I'm fine. I'm okay. I sit home. I have been applying for jobs. I actually went to Amazon because my company closed on the 13th, so I haven't worked since the 13th of March. And I applied for Amazon. I'm just waiting for them to email me back with a start date. You know, okay. But other than that, I'm doing excellent, man. I'm still clean and sober, so that's a plus. I'm sitting here relaxing with my mother.
Nice. How's your mom doing?
She's doing good. She just came from therapy this morning. You know, she had surgery.
Will you do me a favor and tell your mom how proud of you we all are?
Okay.
You know? I don't know if she's within hearing distance, but I would
she's
like
actually,
to.
She's actually right here. She just came in for therapy.
Good morning, ma'am. You are Mr. Strickland's mom.
I'm his mother, but I tell him sometimes I'm his sister.
Okay. Well, I had just asked Mr. Strickland because he said he was at home with you and that he was doing well and that he's clean and sober. And yeah, I said, I'm so proud of him.
I am so proud.
Well, what I just said.
I can sleep now. I can sleep now at night. Before I couldn't sleep, but now I'm sleeping.
I understand. It's got to be a great relief. And what I just said to your son was, can you please tell your mother how proud we are of you, Mr. Strickland, and your progress with us in the program? And so it's a pleasure for me to be able to look you virtually in the eye to eye, and say probably from however many 50 plus miles away I am from you, I would say we're very impressed with your son's progress. And we are so happy that he's in the position that he is in now. And I wanted to tell you that, okay?
Thank you. I appreciate all the help y'all doing for my son. So my kids is my world.
We understand. We appreciate you saying that because as a group, excuse me, rarely do we hear that. You know, I'm blessed because I work with the most consummate professionals who are dedicated to their jobs. And so your thanks is really significant to me. And I'm sure it's significant to everybody else on the team. So thank you, ma'am. We appreciate it.
Thank you, too.
You're welcome.
You and your family have a blessed day.
Thank you. You also.
Okay.
Well, Mr. Strickland, thank you for that.
Now I can see where you get your engaging personality, Mr. Strickland. I'm not sure if we lost Mr. Strickland.
Yes, Judge, we did.
All right. Well, the issue with Mr. Strickland is this. He's doing great. We had a very nice conversation with his mom. And my notes indicate exactly what Mr. Strickland was saying, which is that he was looking for work at the Amazon warehouse. He started the application process, and he may, if he gets hired, he may start as soon as perhaps Saturday. So that's good. And I'll say, Mrs. Semptenfelter, if for some reason Mr. Strickland wanted to have a more lengthy conversation with me, I'd be happy to do it. But I feel like my conversation with him this morning was sufficient and touched on the salient points, okay?
Yes, Your Honor.
All right. Other individuals.
Men Ashley, I'm back.
There he is. He's back.
He's back.
He got disconnected somehow.
That's okay. I just got finished saying to Mrs. Semptenfelter that that you, Mr. Strickland, are doing an excellent job. I understand that if you are going to be hired, you're going to start relatively soon. And so I had just asked that Mrs. Semptenfelter to keep us updated on any progress there. And I said to her that if we got disconnected with Mr. Strickland, if he wants to talk to me about something at some other point, he's always free to reach out to me and we can talk, okay?
Excellent. Thank you, sir. Sir, right. I wanted to ask you one question.
Yes.
And Ashley probably could answer this. Will my phasing up in June be affected by this?
It should
because
not.
I'm scheduled to go to phase three in June.
It should, Mr. Strickland, it should not hold up the phase movements for people who are continuing to do well. That would be the answer.
Excellent.
Okay.
Thank you, sir. I really appreciate you.
All right. Well, Mr. Strickland, I'm gonna move on because I got a lengthy list.
Okay.
I hope you have an awesome day. My best to you and your family, okay?
All right. Thank you, sir. God bless you.
Keep up the good work, my friend.
Yes, thank you.
Thank you,
Ashley.
Bye, Mr. Strickland.
Bye-bye.
All right, so trying to go in some sensible order here on Mrs. Semptenfelter's cases. Ms. Semptenfelter, I have Mr. Burns, Ms. Fries, Ms. Jordan, Ms. Leonard, and Ms. Sutton. And I already see Mr. Brilla lined up for my next portion. So let's see who we can talk to.
Judge, I believe Ms. Maxey has been on for quite some time. And Deja Maxey.
Yes.
Hey.
Ms. Maxey.
Hi.
What's going on with you, Ms. Maxey? I'm not trying to waste your time. I was trying to sort of go through my list here. What is happening with you, Ms. Maxey?
Oh, nothing. I'm stuck in the house.
Okay.
I don't know if I'm enjoying it by now or not. But
yeah, it's kind of like, how old are you, Ms. Maxey?
28.
Yeah, it's like a retirement at 28, right?
I think I'm 27. I'll be 28. I don't know.
It's okay. We're not going to add any more years to you. We'll call you 27, Ms. Maxey. But my point was is that it's pretty early to get into retirement mode, which is a very strange thing, I think, for all of us who are, I mean, you know, we're working, but we're working at home and the hours are different and it's strange. So it's a weird thing for all of us. Are you feeling okay?
If retirement is like this, I don't want to do it.
All right, good. Well, then keep working.
I'm feeling fine, though. I don't know if I was a little late, but I had a whole bunch of games that I downloaded on my phone from pure boredom, and I couldn't get anything off my phone. I had to delete all my games to get on here so I could get the app.
But well, that is not what we want for you, because you know, we want you to be able to continue to do well like you're doing in the program and be able to entertain yourself with some games as well. So you're feeling okay despite being sort of lost by being cooped up all day?
No, I'm fine.
You're fine?
Yes.
Yeah, because the information I get from our senior probation officer Saunders indicates that you're doing well and there are no issues. Because again, I'm asking everybody, how's your family? How are you feeling? You know, any major stressors, any major issues? But like I said, the information I got seemed to be that you were doing quite well. So, you know, anything of note or interest for you, Miss Maxie?
No, not really. I'm just trying to stay out the way, you know.
Yeah.
Away from this virus. I haven't seen any of my family.
Yeah.
My mom came up and cooked, but other than that, I haven't really seen anybody. I've been trying to duck this virus, really.
Yeah, no, and of course, I think that's you know the goal of all of us, and that's why we're making these unprecedented steps of doing what we're doing virtually, because you know, it's a public health and public safety issue, and you obviously understand that. So that's mm-hmm. great. I do not want to take up any more of your valuable time, Miss Maxie. Do you have anything else that you want me to be aware of today?
No, not really, other than I was sent a video from Miss Regina. I could either write an essay or complete the multiple okay. choice, I guess, or something. I'm going to do both because I have nothing else better to do.
Okay.
But
well, I'm
other
sure
than
that,
I just talk sure to her and she tells me what to do.
Okay. Right? All right. Well, and I know that all of our officers, including Mrs. Saunders, are on top of everything. So I rely on their expertise, and you know, I know that you're compliant, Ms. Maxie. So do what you got to do. All right, and we'll continue our conversation on another day. Okay.
Okay.
All right. You take care of yourself. All right.
Thank you. You too.
Thank you. All right. As I only see a certain number of people here, Mr. Potash, as far as the people on Mrs. Sempenfelter's list, Burns, Fries, Jordan, Leonard, and Sutton, I don't see any of those, although I do see Mr. Brilla and I do see Mr. Dunlap, I think, driving.
I'm here.
Who said I'm here?
Tommy Burns.
Mr. Burns, where are you? I'm looking for you. All right. Mr. Burns, good morning. How are you today?
I'm good, sir. How are you?
I'm doing fine. What's happening with you?
Nothing much. I started at Amazon going after a background check. I would start at Amazon on the 25th.
Nice, because I knew you were looking for employment, so that seems to be a good prospect. Is that right?
Yeah, it's something to take up the time, you know, something to definitely help me kill some time. So that's nice.
Yeah, what have you been doing with all the time that you have, Mr. Burns?
Just doing IOP, taking my dogs for long walks. I've been my buddy works at a gym. And so I've been working out with him through Zoom for the past few weeks now.
Okay. That's a good thing. It's good to get the workout in. I was up early and had like an hour walk this morning just to try and make sure my head was clear before we started with court. So you're attending IOP at Solstice, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And what kind of dogs do you have, Mr. Burns?
I have one dog. I'm sorry. She's a lab mix.
Nice. What's her name?
Her name's Boo.
Nice. And so yeah. did you take the dog on a long walk yet today, or is that upcoming?
No, yeah, we went out this morning right before I started this.
Okay, good. You feeling all right, Mr. Burns?
Yeah, so far so good. Going a little stir crazy, but I mean, who isn't?
Yeah, understood. Okay. I mean, you know, we're all facing the same kind of difficulties too. Your family all right?
Yeah, they're still, my mom and dad own a cleaning business, so they've still been, I mean, they haven't had as much clients and stuff as normally they do, but they've still been working throughout this, so.
Okay. Well, good. That's good for you and good for your family. All right. Yeah. Well, I don't have anything else this morning, Mr. Burns. Yeah. I'm going to move on to some other participants. You got anything else for me today, sir?
No, sir.
All right. Well, I greatly appreciate your time this morning. And excuse me. Keep up the good work. And as far as the employment, just, keep us informed as to that. Okay.
Okay.
All right. My best to you and your family, Mr. Burns. You have a nice day. Okay.
Thank you, Your Honor. You too.
All right. Thank you, sir. All right. I'll try it again just on Mrs. Semptenfelter's list. Ms. Fries.
Judge, we have Cassandra Fries checked in.
We do. All right.
Yes.
Because again, Ron, just so you're aware, on my screen right now, where I have it broken up into nine blocks, I have Wendy, John Gaffney, I got DJ Dunlap in his car, I got Ashley, I have Aubrey Gallagher, I got Mr. Brilla looking at me with the American flag in the background, thank you, and then I have fingers that say Pat O'Neill on for some reason.
Danielle Leonard's here, sir.
Okay. All right. Again, I'm just explaining to Mr. Poches the screens that I see because I can't tell who is here. So I want to talk to, of course, Ms. Fries, then Ms. Leonard. Okay. So Ms. Fries, are you there?
Can you guys hear me?
Ms. Fries, I hear you. Can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you.
Hey, good morning. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm doing fine. Thank you very much. I'm trying to have, conversations with all of the phase one and many of the phase two participants this morning. And I'm happy to talk to you. How are you doing?
I'm doing really well. I'm still working because the veterinary field is still considered essential. So.
Yeah, you're reading my mind. That was the first question I asked you because you're a vet tech, right? And my question was whether you still are working. So you are, right?
Yeah, we're still working.
Okay, and how often are you working?
I'm working like 4 days a week, sometimes five.
Okay, fantastic. Yeah. And so that's got to keep you, occupied. Unlike a lot of the people who are just stuck and really held at home, so that's okay for you?
Yeah, no, I enjoy working.
Good.
It keeps me busy. It keeps me focused.
Fantastic. How's your family doing? You're feeling okay? Everybody all right?
My allergies are bothering me a little bit, but other than that, I'm good. My family's all good. We're all good here.
Okay. And are you still attending any sessions at Genesis?
We're not attending IOP right now, but I do have a weekly session with Dara.
Okay. All right. And when is that weekly session? Is that usually on Saturdays?
Mine is on Friday.
On Friday. You plan on talking to her tomorrow?
Yeah. I either talk to her or I talk to Jen.
Okay.
The mental health therapist.
Fantastic. Good. Well, I will say this, Ms. Fries, the reports I get are good. Okay. And that you're compliant. I'm happy to hear that you're well and your family's well. And I'm also happy to hear that, you're one of the few participants who's actually been able to continue working. Okay. So yeah. I would say this, you're very fortunate in that regard because many of the participants I've spoken to this morning have an additional stressor in their lives now that they, have temporarily lost employment. Okay. So hang in there. If there's anything you need from us, don't hesitate to reach out and let us know. All right, Ms. Fries?
Okay, I will.
All right. Well, I hope you have a nice day. And unless you have anything else, I'm gonna move ahead with my list. Okay.
I'm good. Thank you very much. Have a nice weekend.
Thanks, Ms. Fries. You too. Take care of yourself.
All righty.
Thanks. Bye. Ms. Leonard.
Hi, sir. Good morning.
Ms. Leonard, how are you doing? I know that you have been, coping with some issues. I understand that.
I'm sorry, sir. Jack, go lie down. Stop. Hi, the docs, and he thinks he's a Great Dane.
I think that's usually the case with the dachshund, right?
I had to put him on tranquilizers.
Oh my gosh.
He bites everybody.
Is that right?
He does. He goes after everybody that tries to knock on the door. It's terrible. Come here, buddy.
Discriminating as far as who he goes after. He just goes after anyone?
Anyone. Old ladies, kids.
Oh, my gosh. What's his name?
Jack-Jack.
Jack-Jack. All right.
Yeah. I got him at a kill shelter.
Okay. Well, God bless you for that. Yeah, I've got a rescue cat that occasionally takes a chomp out of me for no reason, too. So. I'm not sure if it's because he especially likes me or something else is going on. I don't know.
But, maybe.
Right. So, Miss Leonard, I know that you suffered a loss, and again, my condolences for you on that. I know that you're also addressing things at Legacy. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. All right. Hey, I just wanted to talk to you and let you know that we're here for you, Miss Leonard. You know, and we understand the challenges that you have, and that you're confronting. And again, to pile on top of all of that, our pandemic and all the rest. My concern for you is, of course, on a human level. I'm concerned about you emotionally, and of course, you know, my concerns are any triggers. You know what I'm saying? So you're feeling okay at this point?
No, I don't know what to do. Like the way things are now, he didn't have a will. His kids really weren't in his life. I have the title to his trailer that he signed over to me, and I signed it, but I wasn't able to because motor vehicles is closed.
Right.
And, his kids went to the post office and had all his mail forwarded like 3 days after he died, and him and I had credit cards together.
Okay.
So now my bills are going to their house. I asked them for a power of attorney document notarized, and they wouldn't give it to me. And I'm just, I don't know what to do.
All right.
Legally on my end, like, I don't know what to do.
All right. Well, let me tell you this. I, of course, in my job here, I can't give you legal advice, right? But what we can do as a team is put our heads together and try and figure out what we can do to put you in a position to assist you in this whole endeavor, because we've got the chancery courts or the probate courts having to do with certain issues that you're addressing. Okay. And so again, like I said, I'm not permitted to give you or anybody else legal advice, but I do believe with the wealth of experience we have on our team, we can at least give you some suggestions, or the team can give you some suggestions on how to address some of these sort of complicated legal and quasi-legal issues that have to do with this situation, okay?
Your Honor, okay. If I may, a call to the Burlington County Bar Association would be a good start.
Yeah, I agree with that. Again, we have somebody on the line here, too, who was a former employee of South Jersey Legal Services, and I'm not sure that they would touch anything like this. But again, Bar Association, South Jersey Legal Services, and even going to the ombudsman or reaching out, there are a number of ways, Ms. Leonard, that we can probably point you in the right direction. So don't get despondent over it. I understand that it's challenges that are beyond kind of your control right now. Okay. But you do have people that are willing to assist you. Okay.
Judge, thank you so much.
Yeah. You're welcome, Ms. Leonard. And again, like I said, and I'm going to say this to you before I move on to some other participants. I'm saying this to everybody. If you think that there's anything we can do to put you in a better position to assist you in maintaining your recovery, and addressing these other issues, don't hesitate to reach out to Officer Semptenfelter or Miss Marine, and then we'll put our heads together and see what we can do, all right? We're on your side. We're here to help you, okay?
Thank you, Judge.
All right, Miss Leonard, you have anything else for me today?
No, sir.
All right. Well, I hope you and the dog have a good day, okay? and we'll have a conversation soon, okay?
All right. Thank you.
I wish you the best. You take care. Thank you.
You as well.
Thank you, ma'am. Hi, Ms. Drew. I'm going to start with you. How are you today?
I'm fine. How are you?
I'm doing fine. How is it? How's it at home with the kids?
It's going.
All right. What's happening? Tell me, please.
Well, I'm out of work. So just pretty much home. The kids are on spring break this week, so no school assignments need to be done. Just pretty much been eating and watching TV and lounging around.
Yeah,
I don't have my video on because I'm in my robe and I didn't know if it was appropriate or whatever.
I'm in my robe too.
Yeah, I see.
Different kind of robe, right? Yeah,
yes.
I have my bathrobe on early too. So, but you're doing okay. Yeah, I was curious about, you know, what happened with your employment.
Yeah, the doctor's office is closed, so I'm not on the books right now. I did pick up a private case that I do a couple nights a week, but that's under the table.
Okay. All right. The kids are on break right now. So what are they doing with themselves with no school?
We've been doing a couple of projects around the house. I ordered a vanity for myself and my daughter and a TV stand for my son's room and a gaming chair. So
okay.
We had to put all, you know, assemble everything. So that's been quite a job.
Yes. Yes. I understand. Lots of complicated directions and missing parts probably, right?
Yeah. I'm used to just paying somebody to do it.
Yeah. I understand. Well, I had the challenge. I had the bright idea and since we can't go to any parks and the parks are all closed, I ordered online a basketball hoop for my daughter. And it said that it should be able to be put together in about 3 hours. And about 5 hours later, I was still working on it. But so I know your pain.
Yeah.
If I could have paid somebody to put it together, I would have. But you're doing okay generally?
Yeah, generally I'm okay.
All right, good. Well, I'm going to chat with a whole bunch more people this morning, Miss Drew. So I'm happy that you were able to connect with us. I appreciate your time. I offer the same thing to you that I've been offering everybody. If there's something we can do to make your life easier, better somehow, you let us know and we'll endeavor to do that, okay?
Okay.
All right. Well, I hope you and your family stay safe and stay healthy. And again, I look forward to talking to you at some point very soon. All right, Miss Drew?
Okay. Thank you.
I hope you have a lovely day. Take care of yourself.
You too. Bye-bye.
All right. Thank you. All right. Bye-bye.
Judge, I believe Miss Sutton was able to figure out the microphone.
Miss Sutton.
Hi.
Miss Sutton, how are you today?
I'm okay. I'm all right. I was trying to figure this thing out. Like, I got it, though. I got it.
You evidently did get it. That's fantastic. How are you feeling, Ms. Sutton?
I'm okay. I'm all right. You know, I'm a functional person. So with this whole thing that's going on,
it's like... All right. I know that you've been, inquiring about. Yeah, I can hear you now.
Can you hear me?
Yes. Can you hear me?
Hello. Okay. Now I can hear you. Yeah, my phone was freezing up.
It's okay.
This whole corona thing going on is in a way of stuff.
I agree 100%. This is a wholesale lifestyle change for all of us, you know? Yes. And so I know that you were recently inquiring about phase movement. What we've been telling our participants is that, you know, so long as individuals are eligible for phase movement, otherwise, that there shouldn't be any delay in people moving phases, you know, upcoming months. All right. As a general response to everybody who's concerned, you know, if somebody is doing well and they're eligible to move phases, we're going to continue with phase movements and you know, anything else relevant. Okay.
Good. Because I was asking Miss Ashley, please don't let this get in the way of my phase movement.
Right. Exactly. So long as you're doing
everything. Stay on.
You're
doing the right thing.
There you go. What are you doing with your time? How are you occupying your time?
I'm going to be honest. We're in the house, you know, being safe. You know, I only go out if I got to go grab some groceries from down the street. And, you know, we're staying from around large. Like me, I'm not, like my immediate family, you know, we all live close by. So we're all, you know, separated or whatever. We're practicing a social, you know.
Right. Distance. Exactly. Well, that's a good thing. It's, you know, it's going to keep us all safe, hopefully, in this crazy crisis that we're going through, you know. Right. So. I'm glad that we were able to connect this morning. I'm going to continue on my list, continue down my lengthy list. Is there anything else you think I should be aware of, Miss Sutton? I'm happy, really happy to talk to you. Anything else?
No, you said the right news I wanted to hear. I just
didn't want right, to good.
Interrupt. When you know you're doing right, I don't want to interrupt, you know, with the faith movement. So you said what I wanted to hear.
All right. Good deal. Well, you hang in there, Miss Sutton. It's good to talk to you. Anything we can do to help you out, you let us know. Okay.
Okay. Thank you.
All right. You have a nice day.
You too.
Thank you. All right, Mrs. Semptenfelter, I think that completes your list for the morning, unless I'm missing something. So thank you. We appreciate it.
Thank you, Your Honor.
Moving on to Mrs. Saunders.
Judge, we have Mr. Dunlop.
Yes, I see Mr. Dunlop. Mr. Dunlop, how are you?
I'm doing well. Can you hear me?
I can hear you very clearly. How you feeling? All right?
Yeah, I'm doing well. I had to run. You see me driving. I'm on the way. My phone dying. I was on the way to get a charger, so it wouldn't die on me while I'm on the video.
Good deal. You feeling okay, Mr. Dunlop?
Yeah, everything is well.
Okay.
About to go do some landscape work.
Okay. Yeah. So that's what I was going to ask. What are you doing with your time? You working?
Yeah. Actually, it's been a lot of landscape work, I guess, because everybody home, you know, I guess they realize they need the yard work done.
Yeah.
But, you know, right. I don't touch no money or nothing. They get a cash app.
Okay.
So, you know, I'm still staying safe.
Good. You feeling okay?
Yeah. I'm good. About to go fix my daughter's bike.
Okay. I'm reading some notes here, and I'm not sure. It says it's regarding pretrial services. Have you reached out to pretrial services?
Yes. They called me last week.
Okay. All right. Only because I just have a note here that says that Mr. Dunlap has to contact Mr. Coppola from Pretrial Services. And you've been informed of that. So just out of an abundance of caution, reach out just to make sure that they've got all the information they need about you. All right, Mr. Dunlap?
Okay.
How's your family? Everybody okay?
Yeah, my mom works for New Jersey Transit. They cut it down to 2 days a week now. But, okay. You know, I don't think I ever see my mom work 2 days a week ever in my life.
So right.
It's kind of bad out here.
Yeah, no, it's crazy. Like I was saying this morning, you know, you read the news and there are, you know, 22 million people that are unemployed that were employed 4 weeks ago. You know, I'm sure that's going to rebound, but I'm happy to hear that, you know, you got your like Venmo app or whatever and you're, you know, doing your thing and still able to work and keeping yourself safe, right?
Yeah.
All right. So where are you heading now? Are you driving there or are you stationary?
No, nah, I pulled over once I got the charger.
Okay. All right, good. Well, well, you've been immensely patient this morning, Mr. Dunlap. I know you've been waiting to talk to us. So I'm going to let you go unless you have anything else for me this morning. You have anything else today?
I think that's it. I had something to say, but I forgot. If I remember, I'll call Regina.
Okay. Yeah. Well, we're here for you, Mr. Dunlap. And if there's anything we can do to help you out, you look well and you seem like you're on top of things. Okay. So
all right,
keep doing what you're doing and we'll talk again soon. Okay.
Okay. Thank you.
All right. Thanks for your time, Mr. Dunlap.
All right. No problem.
I see Mr. Hemphill. Mr. Hemphill, how are you? Can you hear me, sir? Mr. Hemphill? He does not seem to be hearing me. I see Mr. Brilla waiting patiently, so perhaps we'll try Mr. Brilla. I can't hear you. You're on mute, Mr. Brilla, but Mr. Potash is going to assist that, I think.
Mr. O'Neill might be ready to, Judge.
Okay.
Hello, sir.
Ah, yes.
How you doing, sir?
Mr. Brilla, I'm fine. How are you today?
I'm doing great. Well, you have kids to get on here.
Yeah, right. Exactly. Was that your daughter, or son?
My daughter, right here. She's sitting in court with me right now.
Hey, good morning. How are you?
Good. How are you?
I'm doing fine. Thank you. Thanks for your assistance, Mr. Brilla. Thank you for your patience. I know you've been waiting a long time this morning. It's a challenge for us trying to go through this, and I'm the one who's got the easiest job here, candidly. So.
I don't know about that.
Yeah. Well. So what's going on? What's going on with you, Mr. Brilla? How are you doing?
I'm doing great. My family's safe. We're all safe, and I'm just doing my program. Not missing a minute or day, or I'm doing everything I have to do.
Good.
I have 10 more weeks to do in my program.
Right on. Well, you've obviously taken advantage of the opportunity that you were afforded when you got into the program. And I recognize that it's not lost on me, and you've been doing everything that you're supposed to do. So I commend you for that. You said you touched on it. Your family's all safe. Everybody's okay.
Yes, sir. Okay. Yes, sir.
And you're feeling all right?
I'm hiding in my room like a bear in a cave. I mean, get a little cabin fever, but I go outside and, you know, pick sticks up or whatever. I just stay in my own yard and I try to stay out of stores.
Yeah. Good. That's smart. That's smart. And you're lucky to have, to have some loving family around you too, to at least keep you company, right?
Big help. It's a big help. Yes, it is.
Nice. So anything else of note or interest with you, Mr. Brill? Anything new or different?
I went from IOP to OP, and like I said, I have 10 more weeks of that.
Yeah.
And I'm on my downfall on that now, so that's good.
Okay.
I went over the hill. I'm going down now to complete.
Yeah, exactly. It's a downhill ride, which should be easier, right?
It's a lot easier, sir.
Good. Yes. Good.
And I appreciate you all. You know, I wasn't sober for 25 years, and I feel great being sober, and I appreciate all your help from you and your staff.
Well, again, Mr. Brill, it's something that we don't often hear. I think it's sort of just taken for granted. And that's why it means an immense amount when we hear an intelligent, articulate person like you say thank you to us. Because, I don't expect to hear it. I recognize it's part of my job, but I have to say that it does feel good to hear it and on behalf of all of us. And I'm looking at all the members of our team here. We appreciate it. And we are here for your help and for your assistance in recovery. And the fact that you would be thoughtful enough to thank us for our efforts, we really appreciate it. Okay.
Yeah, a lot of people take a lot of things for granted, and I did my whole life, and I don't take nothing for granted now. I just appreciate every day, and I appreciate your help. Thank you, because I don't think I can do this myself.
All right. Well, Mr. Brilla, we're going to continue to be here for you. All right? You have any problems, issues, concerns, questions, anything, you know you can reach out to any of us. We're here for you, okay?
Thank you.
All right. My best to you and your family. We'll talk again perhaps as soon as next week, all right?
All right. Thanks, sir.
Take care. Thank you.
Right, bye-bye.
I see Mr. O'Neill. Are you with us?
Yes, sir.
Mr. O'Neill, how are you today?
Good. How are you, sir?
I'm doing fine. Thank you very much. I'm getting a little tired of talking at 11:07, but all is well. Tell me what's going on with you. Are you at Genesis for OPIT?
Genesis, yeah. They're doing everything over the phone. I'm having weekly. Last week I did it on Saturday with Sarah, I believe, or Pam.
Okay.
Well, I did two. Yeah. I did one with Pam, was the intake, and then the other one with Sarah was the actual I don't know what she calls it, the first initial.
Like the intake or something like that. Yeah.
The initial counseling session or something.
Right. Okay. Very good. How are you feeling? What's going on with you and how's your family? Everybody all right?
Yeah, everybody's fine. Everybody's fine. I've been just going from my house to my mom's with the kids.
Okay.
That's what my day consists of.
Okay. And are the kids doing all right?
Yeah. The kids are doing real good. Their birthdays are coming up soon, so I don't know how they're going to take that because they're not really allowed to have any interaction with other people. So,
well, it's interesting you say that because that was a topic that was brought up by my daughter to me yesterday, whose birthday is until the end of June, and said to me, Dad, am I going to be able to have a birthday party? And I said, I don't know, we're gonna have to see what happens. So I've got a kid who's thinking in months and months ahead. So I'm sure that you've got a challenge, but I'm sure you'll be able to surmount that challenge, that's for sure.
Yeah, we'll be fine. I'll just give him a kiss.
All right. Well, what are you doing with the rest of your day, Mr. O'Neill, when we
get I've been trying to find work, but, it's a little improving, a little more difficult than I expected.
Yeah, I think, of course, it's really... probably the worst time in recent memory for people to go out and try and, secure jobs. And then when you tack on the fact that, we got people with criminal histories, it makes it even harder. So look, we're going to work with you, Mr. O'Neill. And like I said to some other participants this morning, if in my discussions with our participants now, we have some who are still working, if they have any insight, any leads onto people that are hiring now during this, we'll let the unemployed participants know, okay?
Absolutely, yeah, I would appreciate that.
All right. Well, I appreciate your time, Mr. O'Neill. You have anything else for me today, sir?
No, that's all.
All right, you keep up the good work. It's good to see you. My best to your family, okay?
Thank you. You too.
All right, take care. Thank you. I see Mr. Hempel there. Mr. Hempel, are you with us?
Yes,
John. Mr. Hempel. Good morning, Mr. Hempel. How are you today? Good
morning.
You doing all right?
Just tired.
All right. My notes are brief, Mr. Hempel, that you're doing well. You're probably tired because you're working, right?
Yes. All right. 7 days a week now.
Well, and you got a baby on the way too, right?
If he's not here before the 25th, the 25th we go into the hospital and he'll be here.
Okay. All right. So you got a lot on your plate. Are you doing okay, Mr. Hempel?
Yes.
All right. You're feeling all right?
Yep.
Okay. All right. Well, you're usually a man of few words, Mr. Hempel, and that's okay with me. I'm not going to try and drag things out of you. All I want you to do is understand this. I appreciate your patience because I know you've been online waiting for us this morning. I'll just say, if there's anything we can do to help you, put you in a better position, I understand for anybody, these are stressful times and you got a baby on top of it and all the rest. So if you need anything, if there's something you think that we can help you with, don't hesitate to pick up the phone, call Mrs. Saunders, call Miss Moraine, reach out to me through one of them. We'll do what we can to put you in the best position, but you seem like you're doing well, okay?
Well, I had two things to tell you. The Dyfus case that's been open for 3 years now with my son Julian.
Right.
Should be closed in the next week or two. Finally.
Fantastic.
And I know it's a little bit of drive for anybody, but South Jersey Bakery in West Deptford, if you go fill an application out, you will start the next day.
Okay. All right. Then I do recognize that it is a ride, but I'm writing that down now, and we'll provide that information, Mr. Hemphill, to some of our participants. And if they have the ability to get there, that's immensely valuable information. So we appreciate it. You please keep up the good work, okay?
All right. Thank you, Your Honor.
All right. It's good to see you, Mr. Hemphill. Best to your family. Hang in there, okay?
Thank you.
Thank you.
Judge, I believe we have Mr. Shork, and that will be the end of my list.
Yes. Mr. Shork.
Hi, good morning.
How are you, sir?
I'm doing pretty good. How are you?
I'm doing okay. What's going on with you?
Just working.
Okay. How's work going?
We're slow, but I get to pick up days since I'm out of program right now. I get to talk on the phone, so I take a little break, but I got to pick up extra days.
Okay, good. How's your family doing?
They're doing pretty good. My girl's working home, from home right now.
Okay. All right. Any problems or any issues, Mr. Short?
No, sir.
All right. Yeah, I I've got notes. I'm not going to get into this. There was something that arose back in March at Unity. But again, I trust probation to address these things. Okay. So no problems, no issues other than that, Mr. Shork. And again, I'm going to offer you the same thing I keep saying over and over to all the participants. Anything we can do to help you out. I understand these are unique circumstances, obviously. We've got a lot of people who are not working. I think you're fortunate to be one of the handful of people that are continuing to work. Okay. So, don't let the bigger picture of what's going on stress you out too much, all right? If you need any help, anything at all, reach out to Mrs. Saunders and reach out to one of us, and we'll do what we can to help you out, okay, Mr. Shork?
Yes, sir.
All right, you got anything else for me today?
No, sir.
All right, I hope you have a nice day. My best to you and your family, okay?
All right.
Take care. Thanks for your time. You too. And Ms. Saunders, that does complete your list for the morning?
Yes, it does. Thank you, Judge.
I appreciate your time and your hard work. Thank you very much. That leaves us with Mr. Peters. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
Mr. Peters, how are you this morning?
Good. Yourself?
I'm doing just fine, thank you. We did address, if I'm sure you heard, we addressed one of your participants, Mr. Brilla, already. And yes. I do believe I see, is it Katavia Robinson?
Yes.
Miss Robinson, I think you're on mute.
Oh, I did.
Ah, there you are. Miss Robinson, good morning.
Good morning.
How are you today?
I'm okay.
What's going on? Please tell me.
Nothing. I'm just ready to go outside.
Yeah, I think that's a sentiment definitely felt by most of the country at this point. That's for sure. I was talking to my wife and daughter. We're together, but I had gone to work for a little bit. They've been locked down even longer than I have. So it's been, 4.5 weeks for them where they haven't really gone anywhere. And so, the stress levels are pretty high.
It's like, I'm not even like an outside person, but now that I'm stuck inside, it's just like, it sucks. But
yeah, in a word, I agree with you. It does. Cause I prefer to be outdoors. Now I'll say this, all the information I get about you is that you're doing really well. Okay. So obviously it's not overwhelming you, right? So you're doing well, and it looks like you're going to be eligible for phase movement perhaps as soon as next month as well. So that's reflective of what's going on with you. Just tell me what you're doing with your time now that you're locked down.
Really nothing. Like, I'm just watching movies. I've been, like, still searching for jobs, even though this is going on. But the jobs I've been looking for are in, like, nursing homes, because I know they would need people, or hospitals and stuff like that. So sure. I'm trying to find something where they want to hire people still. Other than that, like, I'm just in the house. It's, like, nothing to do.
And who else is there in the house with you?
Oh, nobody.
Nobody. It's just you.
Yeah, my daughter, she lives in South Brunswick, but she can't really come over because all this going on.
Yeah, right. And now how old is she?
7.
Okay. And she's in South Brunswick, although not far. You don't, nobody should really be traveling, and then nobody wants to get one another sick. So, yeah, I get it. Have you been talking to her? And
yeah, I FaceTime her every day.
FaceTiming with her. Okay, yeah. All right, good. So, you know, again, I don't feel the need to have an extended discussion with you because you're doing so well. I'm happy to hear, you know, that you're doing okay. Is there anything we can do to help you out? Anything to put you in a better position?
No, my only question is, as far as like if nobody knows when we're going to be able to go back to court, right?
Right.
So as far as that, does the like the movement still move forward even though there's no court? Or
yeah, I and this is a theme that I've had this morning, and so for your benefit, yeah, as long as you're eligible to move phases, this current situation is not going to stop anybody from either moving phases or theoretically graduating. We were, of course, supposed to have our graduation some weeks ago. Obviously, we had to cancel that. But all the people that were eligible to graduate, I went on the record and graduated them. Okay. And anybody that was eligible for a phase movement, I did that as well. So for somebody like you, Miss Robinson, who's doing immensely well and who's eligible for phase movement, that will not stop you from moving phases. Okay.
Okay.
All right. Any other questions?
No.
Okay. All right. Well, then, unless there's anything else, I'm going to move on and try and complete my my morning list. Okay.
Okay. Thank you.
Ms. Robinson, thank you for your time and for your ability to link up with us today. I appreciate it. Keep up the good work.
All right. Enjoy the rest of your day.
Thank you. You too. All right. I believe that I saw
Mr. Torres.
Yeah, Mr.
Torres,
where are you?
I'm here.
Mr. Torres, how are you this morning?
I'm good. How are you doing, Judge Garrenger?
I'm doing fine. Thank you very much for asking. My notes are brief, and they are good, that you're doing well. Okay.
Yes, sir.
You're continuing to attend Legacy for individual sessions, and you're continuing to work. Is that all correct?
Yes, sir.
All right. I'm going to ask you, how are you feeling? How's your family doing and what's going on?
I'm feeling good. Family, they feel good. We all look healthy. We all feel healthy. But, you know, since the pandemic's going on, can't really go in and go out unless necessary. So we've just been spending time in the house together.
Okay. And that's not too stressful for you?
Nah. I would say, like, we're starting to get to know each other a little bit more day by day. That's really what it is. We got nothing but time on our hands.
Yeah, I never thought I could spend more time with my wife or my daughter until I got locked down with them. Yeah, we're learning all kinds of new things about one another, which I didn't think was possible. So I'm with you, Mr. Torres. How often are you working?
Only Sundays and Mondays off. Every other day I'm in there. I'm still working.
Okay. All right. Very good. Very good. Well, what are you going to do with the rest of your day today?
My dad, I would say, just video games. I cleaned up earlier in the week, some video games, and I punched the clock at 3 o'clock.
All right. What game are you playing? What do you like to play?
NBA 2K.
Okay. All right. Now, I'm on MLB, the show guy. So, I may look old, Mr. Torres, but I'm young at heart, all right?
My brother just put me on MLB. It's a pretty good game. I like it so far. It's not bad.
Yeah, nice. Well, maybe we'll have to play one of these days. All right.
Sounds good.
All right. I got to brush up on my basketball skills. So, in any event, Mr. Torres, I'm so happy to talk to you. You're doing really well. All right. We're all very impressed with your progress in the program. I just want you to keep up the good work. You have any issues, anything, you know, reach out to Mr. Peters, reach out to Ms. Marine, to me. We'll do what we can to keep you in the best possible position. Okay.
As will do. Thank you, Jessica Andrew.
All right. You take care of yourself, Mr. Torres. My best to you and your family, okay?
All right. Thank you. You do as well.
Thank you. All right. Mr. Peters, who else do you see that you have here for us?
See Mr. Granville.
All right. Mr. Granville. I'm locked up. I don't see Mr. Granville.
Mr. Boyer.
Hey, guys.
Who am I talking to? Mr. Boyer?
Boyer.
That's me.
Yeah, there you are, Mr. Boyer. How are you? Again, I've got so many screens up here, and it's hard for me to tell who's talking to me because I see your mouth moving and whatnot. So, Mr. Boyer, how are you feeling?
Good.
What's going on? You're working at Amazon, right?
Yeah, somebody in my building got sick, so I've been out for a few days just to be safe, but I'm going back Saturday.
Okay, you're going to go back Saturday. All right. Yeah. How are you doing? How's your family doing?
Everything's good. We're just trying to lay low and, you know, follow these precautions and, you know, going a little stir crazy, but I'm sure everybody is as well.
I agree. We all are. These are really unique times, you know. I don't think, you know, none of us have lived through quite anything like this. So, and, you know, my concern is for all the participants, you know, and whether they can, you know, handle the stress or how they're going to handle the stress. But the word is that you're doing really well, Mr. Boyer. You know, you're working and there are no problems and no issues. You look well. You feeling okay?
Yeah, I'm feeling pretty good.
All right.
You know, like I said, I'm just, as long as I stay off of social media, it seems, you know, less fear.
Yeah, you know. I agree. I try not to watch the news. I really try not to go on social media for the very same reasons, because it starts stressing me out, and I'm a pretty mellow guy to begin with, you know, so it's not good for me, and I recognize it. So you're a smart man, Mr. Boyer, that's for sure. So as far as the rest of your day is concerned, considering you might not go back to work until Saturday, what are you going to do with yourself today?
I've been cleaning a lot, throwing a lot of stuff out, and you know, I'm trying to organize years worth of stuff that's accumulated in this house and stuff like that, you know.
It feels good to organize, and you know, at the end of the day, when you organize your stuff, there's definitely some satisfaction from that. So hey, let us know what happens and keep Mr. Peter posted on you know, on going back to work. We realize it has nothing to do with you. Okay, you want to work, so you know, this is not an issue. Just keep us posted, okay? And if there's anything we can do to help you, put you in a better position, you let us know, Mr. Boyer. Okay?
Yeah. Thank you.
All right. I hope you have a great day. My best to your family, and we'll talk again soon, okay?
Okay. Thank you.
All right. Thanks for your time, Mr. Boyer.
No problem.
All right. We had Mr. Granville. Mr. Granville? I think Mr. Granville's on mute. There he is. Mr. Granville. I'm good. I can't hear Mr. Granville, though. He might need to tap on his audio. If you go on your screen, Mr. Granville, up into the little audio button, it might say, hit that and it'll say connect via internet audio, maybe. Now it says it's connected to audio because it just said it, but I still can't hear you. So that's troubling to me. All right, Mr. Granville, here's the deal. I'm going to right now, and you can hear me, right? You can give me all right. That's what I was going to say. You can give me the thumbs up, the thumbs down, okay? Because I'm nearing the end of a list of about, you know, 60 people this morning. I don't want to give you short shrift, Mr. Granville. So I'm looking at my notes here. You're attending Unity. Presumably you're doing that telephonically or via Zoom. Is that right? Okay. Is that okay with you? All right. Also, that you're working for a mold removal company. Is that correct? All right. Now, I'm going to, is that company based locally? Is it based like in Moorestown? No?
Based out of West Hampton, Judge.
Okay. Only because Mr. Granville should know that I had a mold remediation issue in my house after my fire. So I had a team of people doing mold and water remediation. So I know what he's doing. I've seen the handiwork and I've seen how it's done. So Mr. Granville, that's a good job and it can be pretty lucrative too. So is that okay? And you're still working now? Okay, good. All right. Well, excuse me. My notes are brief, Mr. Granville. You're always interactive. You've been doing well with us. I know you're working, and I know you're doing what you're supposed to do. So my overall question for you is, and you can give me the one thumb up, the two thumb up, thumbs down, one up, one down. Are you doing okay, and is your family doing okay? Okay. All right. Because again, I'm going to offer to you the same thing that I'm saying to all of our participants. All right. I know this is a stressful time. There are a lot of people who aren't working too. You're fortunate to have a job right now. You're doing everything you're supposed to do. If there's something that you need, if you're stressed out, if you're having a problem with something, you know, you can reach out to Mr. Peters as a point person. You can reach out to Ms. Marine from the PD's office. You can reach out to me through anybody on the team, okay? We want you to be a success. We want you to maintain your recovery. You're doing a really good job, okay? So I expect that we're going to talk again as soon as next week. I'm going to give you the double thumbs up, Mr. Granville, and I'm going to bid you a good day, okay? You take care of yourself. Best to your family, all right? Thank you very much. All right, Erin Cunningham, I see.
Yes, sir.
Ms. Cunningham, how are you today?
I'm doing well, thank you.
Nice. What is happening with you? I'm just going to ask you generally. I mean, I know certain things about you, but I want to ask you, how are you doing? Are you okay? Is your family okay? I know that at least as far as I understood, you're living in an Oxford house in Moorestown, right?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay. How are you doing? How's your family doing?
Really good. Everything is going well. You know, with the current situation, I'm actually surprisingly handling things better than ever. I have 9 months on the 17th. So that's
congratulations.
Thank you.
Well, that's great. You know, I've heard from Solstice and they've explained to me that you're doing well. All right. So again, these are the important things that you know, that I pay attention to. It's, you know, your living situation, how you're doing, and you know, whether and to what extent you're attending treatment and what treatment's view is. And I get very, very, very positive reviews. So I want to commend you. I want to tell you that you're doing really well. Okay.
Well, thank you.
I know that you're looking for employment. I've been saying the same thing to everybody this morning, which is, right now, over the last 4 weeks, we recognize that many, many, many people have lost their jobs, okay? And that it is difficult right now to secure employment, okay? And so we recognize that as a team. For those individuals who are actively seeking employment and haven't been able to come up with something, you know, we understand. And we will work with you and do whatever we can to put you in the best possible position to, you know, to be successful. Okay.
Thank you.
So do you, what, I know we've all been locked down. What have you been doing with your time?
I've been helping my sister with the kids and, you know, hanging with the girls here. It's good. I have, at, you know, my home base or whatever, there's recovery. So that was great to transition from long-term treatment into the Oxford house. And I'm so grateful that you've accepted me here in Burlington County, because it really is a great area. You know, I'm optimistic that when things do open up, I'll have no trouble finding a job. So I just have to, you know, keep doing what I'm doing, reaching out when I feel, maybe boredom is a huge thing that we're all going through, but I'm cleaning. That helps me. I don't know. I'm just doing what I can, and I feel really good.
Good. Well, that's fantastic, because again, I'm going to offer to you, Ms. Cunningham, which I'm sure Mr. Peters has and everybody in our program offers. If there's anything that you think that we could do to maintain you in your present good situation or to help you progress, all right, you let us know, because we're only going to know these issues if you bring them to our attention, okay?
Yes.
And as far as, you know, employment's concerned or any other issue, we're going to continue to work with you. I'm blessed because I work with really the best team of people in the state of New Jersey, and so the services that the team can provide, I think, are very valuable. You have our support, okay? And again, I understand that these are immensely stressful times for everybody, and that's why we're trying to have a brief conversation with everybody, just to let them know, hey, we're all in this together. You're doing immensely well. We want you to continue doing immensely well. We recognize the efforts that you're making and the difficulties that everybody's having. So keep up the good work and stay in touch with Mr. Peters and us. And if we can do anything, you let us know. Okay, Ms. Cunningham?
Well, thank you so much. Have a great day.
All right. I hope you do as well. My best to your family. Thank you for your time.
Thank you, sir.
You're welcome.
Judge, we have Shardaya Hughes in.
Miss Hughes. Yeah,
yes, I'm here.
Miss Hughes, how are you today?
I'm doing fine.
Nice. I'm just going through my reams of paperwork looking for my update on you. And briefly, that you're doing well. You're involved with treatment sessions at another open door. That we've got, it looks like, and again, I'm reading the summary here. You do understand that unfortunately, even after sentencing, you're going to have to stick around with us for a while until such time as we're able to do any transfer. You do understand that?
Yes, yes. Miss Nicole, she explained that to me.
Okay, yeah, because I've been in touch with her, and so how are you doing? You driving somewhere? What are you doing?
No. I'm not driving nowhere. I just was sitting in my mom's car because it's quiet right here in the car. It was a lot of moving around going on in my house, so I wanted to be in a quiet atmosphere while I was talking to you guys. But I've been doing okay. I mean, I'm home with my son every day, you know, so I'm homeschooling him, helping him, and. Great. Other than that, I'm reading books. I like to read. So me and my stepfather ordered a lot of new books off of Amazon. So that's pretty much take up my time.
Nice. That's fantastic. That's one of my pastimes as well. So I'm trying to get my 10-year-old to read more. She seems to be more into her iPad than reading, unfortunately. but we can just keep trying, right?
Right, right. Nothing wrong with trying.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. So you're looking well, you're feeling well, and I get good reviews. I know you've been in touch with Mrs. Hoover,
mm-hmm.
Nicole. So, and she's been keeping me apprised of everything that's going on. So so I'm going to say this. I appreciate your time this morning. Is there anything else you have for me today, ma'am, that you want me to be aware of?
No. Other than that, I'm doing pretty good. I'm actually trying to find a job. I know Amazon is hiring like crazy in Florence, so I'm actually trying to get hired up there to see what's going on with that. But other than that, I've been doing pretty good. It's basically to blow over this whole COVID-19 mess so things could just get back on track.
I agree with you. I'm hoping for the same thing. I'm going to offer you, the same assistance, if there's anything you need that you think we can help you with, okay, don't hesitate to let us know, Ms. Hughes. We're here to help you, and we want you to continue, you know, the positive track that you're on, okay?
Okay.
All right. So I appreciate your time and spending a little time with us this morning. My best to you and your family, okay? And go read something enjoyable and relax, okay?
All right. Thank you, Judge.
You have a nice day. Thanks for your time.
All right. You too.
Thank you. Mr. Bolden. You're muted on me, Mr. Bolden. So, there you go. No, you're on now. Mr. Okay. Bolden, how are you doing?
I'm well. How are you?
I'm doing well also. Thank you very much. What's going on with you, Mr. Bolden? You feeling okay? Is your family all right?
Yeah, we're doing good. I have family next door, so I've just been helping them out with, you know, going out and doing some grocery shopping for them. They're a little bit older, so, you know,
okay. They
don't want to risk going out.
Yeah, no, I understand. I've actually done some shopping for an elderly neighbor as well. Just reached out, and they were grateful and said, yeah, it would really help if you picked up this or that. And so I just added it to my own list, you know, little things that make a big difference in people's lives. You're very thoughtful, Mr. Bolden.
Thank you.
So what else do you have going on?
Nothing much, man. Just getting some yard work done, doing some work around the house now that I have downtime, because I feel like if I didn't take advantage of this time right now, that I would regret it later on. You know, with everything going on, with life returning back to normal once it does, I will regret it not utilizing this downtime to get some things done around the house.
Yeah, I think that that's wise, because the tendency is to kick back, and then if that's the case, you're gonna not have accomplished much. So I find myself trying to clean out a closet, or, you know, work on the garage or whatever it might be. So I think it's good, because once things change and you go back to work, you're gonna say, oh, why didn't I do this or why didn't I do that? So
right.
You're a smart man, Mr. Bolden. Are you still attending Legacy?
Yes. I've been talking with my counselor on the phone. We've been having phone sessions.
Okay. All right. And look, I got to say, you've always been, you've always been an excellent participant. You're looking well. You sound like you're feeling well. Is everything okay on your side?
Yes, everything is good. I'm doing okay in this trying time.
Yeah. And again, you know, my concern always is, you know, initially and primarily for the participant, and then it's for the participant's family. And, my thoughts are always, with you and with your family. Things are okay with everybody?
Yes, everything's fine. This past Saturday, I have celebrated 1 year clean. And I have my, I don't know if you can see it, I have my...
I do.
Medallion.
Mr. Bolden, congratulations.
Thank you very much, Your Honor.
Yeah, we're impressed. I can say I'm impressed with you and your progress. And again, I always am immensely grateful because of your ability to engage in the way that you do, Mr. Bolden. You're an engaging young man, and you have a lot to offer. And I'm really happy to see that you've put yourself in a position to continue on a trajectory of success.
Yes.
I see it. I see it. I sense it. I feel it. And so, I want you to understand from somebody that doesn't know you other than, from our discussions, in court, and from what I read about you, but the sense of success that I feel from you is palpable. It's real. Okay. So don't forget that, Mr. Bolden. Don't sell yourself short. You're doing an immensely good job. Okay.
That means a lot to me, Your Honor. Thank you.
Well, I appreciate it. Your efforts mean a lot to me, and they mean a lot to the team, because they, you know, prove to all of us that you're somebody that certainly is beyond worthy of being offered the opportunity that you have because of the way you've taken advantage of it. Okay. Yeah. So unless you have anything else for me, I'm going to bid you an excellent day, and I hope the best for you and your family. Okay.
Thank you very much, Your Honor. You have an excellent day as well.
All right. I'll do my best. Thank you for your time, Mr. Bull, and have a good one.
Thank you. You too.
Thank you. Ms. Bush.
Hi.
How are you?
I just figured this thing out. I'm good. How are you?
I'm doing great. Thank you. It's good to see you. You feeling okay?
Yes, I'm feeling good. I'm at work. I've been working. Thank God.
Yeah, because I in the notes that I was reviewing from Mr. Peters and my discussions with him, you know, you're one of a handful of people that's still working, which is a really good thing for you. You doing okay?
Yes. Oh, I'm doing great. Yes. I'm tired. I'm getting used to working again. It's been a while, so.
Yeah, good. And are you still at the Oxford House in Mount Holly?
Yes. Yes, I am. Okay. It's great. I love it. All right.
That's what I was going to ask you. Your experience is good still, right?
Yes. Oh, yeah. No problems at the house or anything. The girls are great. We do Zoom meetings, NA meetings on the phone.
Great. Uh-huh.
So that's been good, you know.
Nice. Nice. Yeah. And, you know, Solstice has explained that to me that you're doing well also. So, you know,
I go there every Tuesday, you know. Yeah. I go in on Tuesdays, and then I do the Zoom on Saturdays.
Okay. So it all seems to be working for you, Ms. Bush, right?
Yes, everything's going along great.
Fantastic. Yeah, and again, you know, for all the people that I've talked to this morning, I've sort of touched on the same theme, which is I know that these unforeseen circumstances of being locked down and the fear associated with everything. And I just wanted to make sure that A, you're doing okay, which evidently you are. You're doing really well. And B, I just wanted to make sure that you understood that we're all here for you, starting with Mr. Peters and Ms. Moraine and myself and all the other members of the team. We're here for you because we realize that for some participants, these issues, these social issues that are going on right now are real stressors, okay? Stressors, okay? And right. I just want to offer to you, and again, I don't think that you need it right now. You're doing immensely well. But again, just so that you and I are clear, that if there's something that we as a team can do for you to put you in the best position to continue your recovery, you please let us know, because we're not going to know unless you tell us, okay?
Right, definitely. Definitely will. And I appreciate that. Thank you very much.
You're welcome. So do you have anything else going on of note, or are you going back to work? Are you done, or what's your deal?
I'm actually on my lunch break. So this is very good. Very convenient. This was. Yes.
Well, I'm sure you did enjoy your lunch more than talking to us.
I can still eat now. I can still go eat.
Good. Well, I've got a couple more people that I'm going to talk to. I've been on the record since 9 o'clock this morning without a break. Now that's okay. It's what I want to do. Okay. So, but I'm going to offer you an opportunity. Anything that you think we should be aware of, you know, with you?
No, everything's going smoothly. Everything's great in my life. Yes. I'm very happy.
Fantastic, Ms. Bush. Well, then I will not take up any more of your valuable time. Enjoy your lunch. Enjoy work. Enjoy, you know, all the things that your recovery has provided to you, okay? If we can help you, let us know, okay?
Okay, great. Thank you, Mr. Garrenger.
All right. I hope you have a wonderful day. Thanks for your time.
You too. Thank you.
Thank you. Keep up the good work. Yes.
Mr. Peters has Mr. Horniker standing by on his cell phone, and then we have one more participant listed under Costello Law Firm.
Okay. And who is that under the last one?
That would be Ms. Keys.
Okay. All right. Yeah. So, Mr. Peters, you have Mr. Horniker?
Yes, Judge. I have him on the cell phone right here.
All right, Mr. Horniker, can you hear me, sir? Mr. Horniker, can you hear me? Okay. I just wanted to say hello this morning, Mr. Horniker. My understanding is you completed long-term at Damon House, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And you're attending IOP in Morris County. Is that correct?
Yes, sir. St. Clair's. I'm moving.
Okay. All right. And you have where are you living right now?
In
okay. All right. You know, eventually you're gonna transfer to Morris County, I'm sure, as Mr. Peters told you. But in the interim, you know, you're gonna have to kind of stay with us until we get through all of these issues. You understand?
Yeah, absolutely. I understand.
All right. Well, Mr. Horniker, I'm just gonna simply say this. I'm gonna offer to you our assistance. In any way, shape, or form so that you can continue your successful recovery, all right? I know that you know how to reach out to Mr. Peters, but if there's any of us on the team, including Ms. Moraine from the PD's office or anybody else, any of us can do anything to help you, you let us know because we want you to be a success, okay?
I appreciate that, Ron.
All right. Well, unless you have anything further, Mr. Horniker, I appreciate your time, and I wish you continued success, and again, offer our services to you moving forward, all right?
I appreciate that very much. Thank you.
All right. Thank you very much, Mr. Horniker. Mr. Peters, thank you very much.
Thank you, Josh.
All right. And Ms. Keyes.
Hello. I'm sorry.
What are you? You got nothing to be sorry about. How are you doing today?
I'm doing well. How are you?
I'm doing fine. Thank you very much. Good. It's good to see you. What's good going to see on? You.
Nothing. I'm on my daughter's laptop, and I've never done Zoom, so.
All right. Well, hey, here you are, and you're doing a great job with it, you know?
Thank you.
I was a novice until about 3.5 weeks ago, and yeah. I'm looking around at I'm looking at our team leader, Mr. Potash, in court all the time. And Mr. Potash, I want to commend because he has now become the Zoom master of ceremonies. right. So we appreciate his. He's shaking his head no, but he is. he was able to get all this accomplished. So Ms. Keyes, about you, how are you doing? Yes. What's going on?
I'm doing well.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm doing good. I mean, I'm home. I'm glad to be home. I'm so thankful and grateful to be here. It just sucks that, you know, the rest of this stuff's going on. But other than that, I'm doing well. Thank you.
Yeah. Well, and I would say to you this, maybe 6 months or a year ago, you know, you pick the time back in time and think right. about, you know, this pandemic happening then and what your reaction to it would have been and many, many, many others, which would have been highly destructive probably. And so look, yes. you're here, yep. you're here, you're healthy and yes. you know, and that's what we're so happy for. Okay. Right. So, yeah, this is one of the reasons why I wanted to reach out. We all wanted to reach out one-on-one with the participants because I don't know the reactions that certain people are having versus others. You know what I mean?
Right.
Because,
right.
you know, different people have different support structures, et cetera.
Right.
So you seem like you've got your family support.
Yep.
And yeah, and I'm just looking at my notes. You know, I've heard very good things from treatment as well. So
thank
you know,
you.
These are the important things to me. They're the signals that somebody is either doing well or struggling. And
right.
all the signals I'm getting from you, Ms. Keyes, are that you're doing well. So
thank
you're
you.
Feeling all right. Okay.
Yes, I am. Thank God. right.
Yeah.
Right.
Well, I'll say this. Don't try not to let everything, you know, stress you out. I know it's much easier said than done. I go through waves of it myself where, you know, at times I say, oh, well, you know, everything's fine. And at other times I, you know, I get myself into a little bit of a panic situation, worried about my family, worried about my other friends and loved ones and colleagues and everything else. So, you know, so it's natural, but I wanted to offer to you, again, our continued assistance. All right. You have all these people pulling for you. Again, I'm looking at a screen, a split screen of 9 people, right? And I've got you, and I've got all these other drug court staff, and I'm looking and I'm saying, here's somebody who's here to help. Here's another person who's here to help. Here's another person who's here to help, you know? And, and again, I have a kind of a different role here, but again, my offer to you is the very same thing. If we can put you in the best position to maintain your recovery, we're not going to know unless you tell us, okay? Unless you are having an issue. So I see Mr. Peters' smiling face, and I know Mr. Peters is anxious to assist anybody who needs any assistance, okay? As are we all. So so that really kind of concludes, you know, what I wanted to say. Anything you think I should know about Ms. Keys, and anything you think is relevant?
Not really. I just thank God or hope that all you guys are safe, because I know it's like scary out there.
It is. It is. Yeah. Well,
not that I go out there, but I know it's scary out there. Right.
Yeah. Well, it's also stressful. I mean, I've gone over this, and I know all my colleagues are sick of hearing me repeat myself, but you know, I'm locked down here with my wife and my daughter too. And I've been married to my wife for a couple decades. All right. And all of a sudden I'm learning things about her that I didn't even know. Because we're cooped up all day, and my daughter likewise. I mean, I raised her, and I'm still learning things about her. So it's a weird situation, and you know, we're all trying to get through it as best we can. I just don't want the stresses associated with it to impact your recovery. If you're feeling stressed, you're feeling like any of us can help, don't hesitate to reach out, because we are here for you. We will continue to be here for you. Okay.
Thank you.
All right. You are welcome. Well, with that being said, I don't think I have anything else, Ms. Keys. Anything else you want us to be aware of before I terminate our call?
I don't think so.
Okay. Well,
but thank you.
Again, my best to you and your family, and thanks for your developing technological ability to link up with us. Okay.
Thank you. That's my daughter, but thank you.
Well, if you could kindly thank your daughter for us.
I will.
Okay?
I will.
You have a nice day, Ms. Keys. Thanks for
your time. Thank you. Stay well.
Thank you also. All right. I suppose I'm turning back to Mr. Potash, Mr. Gaffney, Ms. Moraine, Mr. Peters. I think, and Ms. Hoover, I see you appear out of the ether. Ms. Saunders. Mr. Griffin, Mrs. Emptenfelder, everybody has now appeared. Does that complete our morning list as far as you're all aware?
Yes, Judge. Mr. McDowell's going to be at 1:30.
Okay. All right. Mr. Griffin, did you have anything?
No, just my other two will be here at 3.
Okay. All right. Mrs. Saunders, anything?
Not for this morning, Judge.
All right. Mrs. Emptenfelder, anything?
Nope, that's it, Judge.
Ms. Moraine?
Well, Your Honor, what do we do now? Do we stay connected, put it on mute, and come back at 1:30 or what?
Yeah, that's a good question. I'm not sure if we get another invite for this afternoon.